Tonight, in an unprecedented event, live podcasting reaches a new milestone. While most live shows stopped in 2020, only one kept going. Their overwhelming need to please the fans and collect ad money kept them going. A show that started in the small room at the Comedy Store in Hollywood would soon be filling up the big room at the Comedy Store in Hollywood. Then it hit the road. Toronto, Houston, Dallas, New York City, Boston, Vancouver, Nashville, Chicago, Sacramento, San Francisco, Seattle, Portland, Las Vegas, Raleigh, Atlanta, Boise, Pasadena, San Diego, Ventura, Phoenix, Philadelphia, Pittsburgh, Columbus, Cleveland, Salt Lake City, San Antonio, Detroit, Indianapolis, Kansas City, Milwaukee, Madison, Des Moines, Calgary, Montreal, Poughkeepsie, Buffalo, Dublin, Ireland, Manchester, England, London, England, Miami. And now it accumulates to this. Live from its new home in Austin, Texas, the first ever live podcast to hit 500 episodes and the number one live podcast in the world. Live from the Paramount Theater in Austin, Texas, this is Kill Tony 500.
This is Redman coming to you live from Austin, Texas, at the Paramount Theater for Kill Tony 500. Here's Tony Hinchcliffe! Austin, Texas, we're here. Make some fucking noise. Come on! Brian, Redman's
here. Hey, everybody!
It's all happening. How about a hand for the fucking band, huh? Come on, everybody. It's the Kill Tony Band. Sponsored by Fix Vodka, the first ever alkaline vodka. Nice, clean hangovers. No hangovers, I mean. It's a nice, clean vodka with no hangovers. Get yourself a nice, clean hangover from our new sponsor. I love it. Ladies and gentlemen, right behind us, the great Ryan J. Ebelt is drawing tonight's episode as we speak. You can't even miss him. He's right here. The real Ryan J. Ebelt flew in from Los Angeles, California for this. How many of you have been fans of the show for a long time, huh? Very exciting. You know, we wish episode 500 would have landed with an opportunity to have full capacity, but you fucking monsters that bought up these first 400 tickets as fast as you did. Congratulations. It meant the world to us. We're excited. Happy to be here. Have a hell of a show planned for you. Our bellies are full thanks to our friends over at CM Smokehouse at Bolden Acres. We all had full meals. It's a big, big theater prep day for us, and we scarfed down some food, including some brisket cheesecake. That was cheesecake with brisket. And I don't know if you guys can tell, but I've actually gained, and it's not easy for me, 7 pounds since moving to Texas. Thank you very much. I wear it right here in my neck. So thanks to Yoni, Best Barbecue Show, and everybody there. And before we start tonight's incredible episode, here's a little bit more about the amazing sponsors that made it available for you right now, here, at this moment. Guys, we've talked about it before. We're talking about it again. Truly one of my favorite products that I've found in the past year. It is unbelievable. It's Liquid IV. With one stick of Liquid IV and 16 ounces of water, you get 2 to 3 times the amount of hydration as plain water. This is a game changer for me. After golf, after shows, waking up hungover, you name it, Liquid IV is a magic trick for life.
Tony, I brought some of my personal stash for us today. Yeah. They have the new strawberry. They have the new pina colada. I don't know if you've tried that yet. And my favorite is the passion fruit. Now, we've been talking about Liquid IV before they've even been a sponsor. I've always had a problem drinking water, and this has changed my life. These contain 5 essential vitamins, more vitamin C than an orange, and as much potassium as a banana. It's healthier than the sugary sports drinks that I used to be addicted to, and no artificial flavors or preservatives, and less sugar than an apple. It's made with clean ingredients, non-GMO, vegan, and free of gluten, dairy, and soy.
I'm telling you, I got off an airplane today, and that's one. It's another one of the areas where it's just incredible how well it works. Rehydration to the max. It's absolutely incredible. Again, this is a product we were talking about before they were even a sponsor. It's absolutely, and they're great people. They donate 3.7 million servings in response to COVID-19. They're donating them to hospitals, first responders, food banks, veterans, and the active military. And they've donated over 6.7 million servings globally. Grab your Strawberry Liquid IV or any one of their other great flavors in bulk nationwide at Costco, or you can get 25% off now when you go to liquidiv.com and use the code Tony at checkout. That's 25% off anything you order when you use the promo code Tony at liquidiv.com. Get better hydration today at liquidiv.com, promo code Tony. This podcast is brought to you by the Ridge Wallet. It's light, sleek, and industrial. It doesn't fold or awkwardly bulge in your back pocket, and it seriously changed my whole pocket situation. It's designed to fit easily in your front pocket. I was having some neck problems earlier this year. Turns out, you move that stuff to your front pocket, it's a whole nother level. Most people are still using wallets designed in the 90s, carrying around old receipts, pictures of their ex, and gift cards in an unorganized mess. I mean, you know about this. You have a bunch of fast food place cards in your wallet.
Come on. No, but I do think a lot of people like us still carried around that old wallet, you know? This one holds up to 12 cards, plus it has room for cash. There are over 30 colors and styles. I got the carbon fiber one. It's awesome. If this wasn't enough to win you over, check out the 40,000 five-star reviews. The durable material means each wallet comes with a lifetime warranty. You could buy this wallet and carry it for life. The Ridge team is so confident that you'll like it that they'll give you a 45-day trial. You can test it out for 45 days. If you don't like it, you could send it back for a full refund if you don't love it.
Look, I'm telling you, people, every single cast member of Kill Tony has one. They use it. It absolutely works. It's sleek. It makes sense. Get your life together. Get rid of your silly, chunky wallet that your grandpa gave you and have a better life with the Ridge Wallet. Get 10% off today with free worldwide shipping and returns by going to ridge.com/killtony. That's ridge.com/killtony. Use the code word killtony. Don't forget, get 10% off. It's an amazing thing. Treat yourself. You'll thank me later. And we're back. Are you guys ready to start the show? Very, very exciting. But you know what? I think before we bring out, we do have a guest tonight, but I think before we bring him out, maybe we should bring out, you guys think we should add one more band member tonight? Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to do it. It's happening right now. From Los Angeles, California, this young lady became a band member on Kill Tony a little over a year ago. She is here tonight. You know her. You love her. Rev those engines for the great Jet Ski Jesse Johnson, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, shit. It's the real... Oh, my God.
She's making it rain.
It is happening. She is here. She's shooting cash everywhere. This is unbelievable. The real deal, one of the veteran band members from Los Angeles. Where have you been, Jet Ski? What's been happening?
It's crazy out in LA. This is what we all dress like now. It's weed's illegal again. Harvey Weinstein's back. It's just a nightmare.
Jet Ski's going to be with us all night. For those of you that have been fans for the show for a long time, you know how big of a deal that is. We're super pumped. You guys ready to meet tonight's guest, huh? Hey, ladies and gentlemen. One of our favorite guests in the world, our veteran guest here in Austin, Texas. This guy hangs out with us all the time. Loves it. We love him. One of the best comedians in the world. One of all of our best friends. Ladies and gentlemen, make some noise for tonight's guest, Joe Rogan, everybody. Come on. Come on. God damn it. Yeah. Here we are. We're having fun. We're in Austin, Texas. Hey, Joe. Come on, come on. Joe Rogan. We've done a few of these in the past.
Done a few, my friend.
We've been having fun at our usual home of Antone's, but here we are at the Paramount.
This is dope.
I'm excited about it. I'm pumped. And so let's just jump right into it. You know how this thing works. Everybody does. I had a bunch of people signed up before the show. I'm sure a lot of first-timers. Usually at these theater shows, you get a lot of people that have been hoping for years and whatever to do it, and they sign up. If I pull your name out of the bucket, there's two staircases, one there and one there. Those are your only two options. You come right up those. You perform behind that microphone for 60 seconds uninterrupted. You know your time is up, and you hear the sound of a kitten. There it is. She's excited tonight. Wrap it up then, or else you're going to bring out the angry Fifth Street Bear. There it is. That's it. You guys ready to start tonight's show or what? Let's go. But since it's episode 500, before we go to the bucket, I think we should give you guys a special treat. You guys like special treats? Then I present to you a brand new 60 seconds from one of your favorite regulars in the history of the show, the longest standing veteran regular in the history of Kill Tony. He is the Big Red Machine. His name is William Montgomery. Here we go.
Make some noise, Laredo! Let's give it up for the Round Rock Express! What about the Rice Owls?
Okay. I heard the Austin City Limits Festival is having to cut back on its budget. Instead of a Tupac hologram this year, they're going to have a claymation Frank Zappa. New study finds tripping on your airplane stairs reduces coronavirus. New study finds letting immigrants into the country with coronavirus reduces coronavirus. I just joined a rock band and it's called Rock Band. I only have one controller and you have to watch me play. I have a buddy who is a heroin addict, and as a prank I sold him the COVID-19 vaccine. Look, I'm an anti-Semite too, but I'm not trying to gas chamber Dr. Seuss.
There it is. Lock it down. Every week, a new 60 seconds from a stone-cold assassin, William Montgomery.
So nice to be here. I actually took some Adderall earlier.
I love it,
William. I've been looking at maps.
Okay. Love it. You dress like a little bit of a cowboy tonight. You did like me, except you look like a man and I look like Gay Woody from Toy Story.
You've got a friend.
There's a snake in my butt.
Yeah, I got this at JCPenney earlier. I stole it. I was on Adderall.
His commitment's remarkable.
Yeah, you've seen William a couple times, right, Joe? What do you think about this?
Very funny dude, man. Wild Very stuff. Funny. You're funny in a really unique way, too. It's cool to watch.
Thank you. I look forward for you inviting me on your podcast. I think it'll be a lot of fun.
Let's try it again when you don't stumble. You get a part of that. It'll have more effectiveness.
I'm sorry. I'm on Adderall right now.
Did you think about when you were at JCPenney stealing that shirt, did it all cross your mind to perhaps steal a belt? It's very obvious that you're not wearing a belt.
What are you talking about?
I mean, like, you're not only are you not wearing a belt, but your belt loops are like Audis. They're not even like innies. They're
no,
like,
it didn't fucking cross my mind, no.
Your belt loops are like
the
reaching.
The fuck are you talking about, Tony?
They're reaching out, hoping that a belt will come to them. William, you just flew into Austin. You've been living in L.A. What's going on out there? What's happening out here? What do you think about all this?
Seems really cool. Who said yeah? Who's trying to fuck this up for me? This is probably the biggest opportunity I've ever fucking had. And some fucking dumbass is doing that. Please stop. Please fucking stop. I'm not kidding. I swear to God, I'm not fucking kidding right now. This is one I took too much Adderall earlier. I'm totally fucking on edge. My heart is breathing out of my chest.
William.
But yeah, it's been really nice. It seems like a nice place to be.
Can I ask you like a comedy question?
Yeah.
What's your writing process like? Because your stuff is all like silly, sort of non sequiturs. Like, how do you just sit down? Do you come? How do you do it?
I will. To be quite frank, I will. There are many times I'm not prescribed anymore, but I will take an Adderall pill and I will smoke some weed, and I feel like the Adderall sort of gets me in the zone. And then the weed, I'm thinking silly. And then I write it down.
I believe you. That explains a lot. It's great stuff, though, man. Really funny.
Were you on Adderall when you committed to talking about Adderall for half your set?
I actually wasn't. I actually haven't taken Adderall today.
Oh.
Wow. You had to.
What a twist.
No, actually, my drug dealer in Los Angeles, I bought 10 Adderall pills for $600.
That doesn't seem like a good deal at all.
It doesn't at all.
Were you on Adderall when you did
that? I was on Adderall when I bought the Adderall. Joe, you might like this. I've said it once before, but one of my best jokes is the guy who invented Adderall must have been on Adderall.
It really works better if you don't do it like right after the joke about Adderall and Adderall. You really stepped on
it. It's like a technical thing.
Yeah.
This is just a preview of the JRE episode that you'll still see in the future.
William, what are your favorite things about Austin when you visit here?
Oh, man, the color yellow is everywhere. It's my favorite color. It's like everywhere I walk around, I see the color yellow. It's one of my favorite colors. I'd say that's probably the biggest thing right now.
And how does the rest of the country not know about queso?
Yeah, that's crazy.
That's a big deal.
Do they have the white cheese dip here?
Yeah,
yeah, whatever the
queso.
Fuck you want. But the fact that the rest of the country has like bullshit queso. Yeah.
Did you have queso before you moved to Los Angeles though? Because when I was in Ohio and I moved to LA, I was really pissed off that the Mexican food didn't have queso, and I always.
Do you think Mexican people are mad at Tex-Mex?
Yeah.
Yeah, they are.
Are
for
you?
Sure. Yeah, Michael Gonzalez, our new resident Mexican drummer over there.
Like Tex-Mex?
I was talking about Matt's El Rancho the first few episodes.
They get mad at you.
Here. Yeah, he was really mad. He's like, yo, dude, if you really want... You're talking about, like, Tex-Mex. If you want Mex-Mex...
Are you really Mexican?
Yeah.
Cool.
But he sent me to this place. With that said, he did. He sent me to this place called Polvo South, and I was hooked.
The real shit.
Yeah, now when the wait's too long at Matt's El Rancho, I go to the Mex-Mex.
Are y'all really black? Cool.
William, I don't think you can talk like that wearing a shirt like that.
What does that mean?
I think it worked for you like when you were wearing like rockers.
What does that fucking mean? No, what does that mean?
What does that mean, right?
No, what does it mean? Yeah,
what man. Does that shit mean, bro?
What does it mean, Tony?
What does it mean?
I mean, I'm just saying, you used to wear more likable t-shirts.
Okay, okay.
Now
okay.
You're dressed like an adult. People are going to take you seriously.
Cool.
You're dressed like how like we like the difference between that you in a t-shirt and you in that is before you look like you, and now you look like what we think your dad looks like.
Sweet Larry Montgomery.
I think it's a good curveball, honestly.
Mm-hmm. Thank you.
I think if you came up with like a wacky like rock t-shirt on, people would see more coming.
Yeah, but you know? I don't. I just wearing that. I think I'm going to just keep wearing this shirt.
Yeah, just leave it on.
It's a good shirt, but it's just a framework.
I think I'm going to keep...
You can build on that framework. You can have similar sort of misstyled attire and put it all together.
I'm thinking
people
about
like, what
it.
Is this guy doing? And then, boom, you hit him with the good jokes.
I'm thinking about it. Maybe I'll start wearing this shirt all the time. What do y'all think, Laredo?
Maybe get one with rhinestones.
William, you've been visiting every couple weeks for like each month or so. Is there anything you'd like to tell these people here about any decisions that you made in the past couple weeks?
Yeah, I don't know if y'all have ever heard of the burger place called Wendy's, but I highly recommend it. There's some Wendy's in Austin. Dave's Doubles. I get a couple Dave's Doubles.
William, you maybe want to announce that one thing?
Yeah, I'm moving here.
Oh, wow. I don't think anybody saw that coming. Come on, Laredo! You got an apartment in Laredo.
I know. I'm still looking for apartments. So if somebody has an open place, let me know.
Take him in. Take him in. Take him in.
Joe, you have probably an open spot. Okay.
That was just like your average liberal's reaction to real immigration. Not my house. Right. Take him in. Not here. Over there.
William, another great minute. You've been doing this longer than anybody. A total accumulation. You've written hundreds of minutes on this show right in front of these viewers' eyes, and it's absolutely incredible. Congratulations on your new move to Austin, Texas. And,
thank you. I look forward to it.
Way to get the show started. Ladies and gentlemen, it has begun with the stylings of William Montgomery.
Dude, that was really good. Really good. It was awesome.
There goes William.
He's a funny dude.
Hell yeah, he is. Oh, look, it's Zach Bogus, everybody. Well,
oh. We should upgrade him.
Yeah, we did. We did.
One day we're going to get to a point where we're not so scared to use the same microphone.
There goes
one day,
Zach Bogus.
One day.
Yeah, I know, right? People are safe here in Austin. Ladies and gentlemen, your next comedian goes by the name of Lucas McCrary. Here we go. Your first bucket pool of the night. Anything can happen. We've had legitimate homeless people. We've had everything on this show. We've pulled everything out of the bucket. There's a rumor going around that there's a guy handing out 100 T-shirts with Casey Anthony on them that just say Tony Hinchcliffe underneath her.
What?
I saw that. So shout out to whoever's bombing from the sidewalk.
Is that true?
Oh, here he is. It's Lucas McCrary, everyone. Here we are.
Hello, everyone. So a little bit about myself. It's why we all came out here tonight. So I am I'm non-binary, right? So I use... I use they, them pronouns, and I have to remind my dad about this a lot because it's still a pretty new thing. So I'm like, hey, Dad, you know, if you don't mind, I use they, them pronouns, but it doesn't matter how many times I remind him because he keeps calling me faggot. Thank you. It's actually on my birth certificate, Faggot McCrary, that's my name. Better than my sister named Disappointment or my brother named Elliot, you know, fucking... Garbage name, garbage person. So what's it mean? What's it mean to be non-binary, right? So gender is a spectrum. So you got man, woman, everything in between. So some days I feel like I am a woman, and other days I'm funny. So still trying to figure it out. Thank you. I'll leave it at that.
Wow,
dude, that was really good.
Lucas McCrary.
That was very funny. Very funny.
Thanks, Joe.
Hell yeah. Welcome to the
show. Really good.
Welcome to the show. How long have you been on stand-up?
I've been doing it about 3 years now.
3 years? All of it here in Austin, Texas?
No, Tennessee. So I've been here about 2.5 months.
That was good stuff, man. Really clever. Really sneaky.
Thank
it was
you.
Awesome. That was really funny.
You doing it all in Nashville?
No, Knoxville, Tennessee.
Wow.
Yeah,
what's the
baby.
Scene like out there? Is it just you?
Yeah. It's me and like 20 other active comics. It's very small.
Okay.
Would you guys set up your own shows in bars and stuff?
Coffee houses, old movie theaters and stuff.
Damn.
Yeah. Yeah, it was fun. Yeah, if you could really draw a crowd because there's nothing else going on.
Wow. Look at you. How old are you? You look somewhere between you look like someone like a young boy and a
you,
werewolf
Tony?
At
How
the same time. This is incredible.
No, he might be 40 or he might be 8.
Yeah. I'm 24.
24 years old. What do you do for work?
I make posters and album covers.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. And you make a living off that?
Right now, yeah. I live very minimally, so it's
he sells drugs, right?
Yeah, it seems like it.
Dude, I'm looking at this guy. I'm like, get in the fucking car. Shut up.
Now, do we say he or do we say it or what is the proper thing to say?
Yeah, I prefer it. I prefer trash. If you want to spit on me, that'd be good.
No, I mean, what is it?
So is that all true, though? Do you really identify as non-binary?
Can't you just keep the mystery, Tony?
I don't know. Let's talk about it.
Yeah, I do.
You do?
Yeah.
So, like, what exactly does that mean to you?
I think it's different for everyone, but for me, it's just, like, I don't really care about... What gender stereotypes and stuff. For me, it's just a way to get around like the idea of what a man or a woman should be and just lets me kind of do my own thing.
He's the future. We're all going to be aliens, little genderless aliens with giant heads. And this is just one step.
I was going to say the exact same thing.
But listen, man, you know what? You're like the first person who's like openly claiming non-binary that wasn't slightly annoying.
Thanks.
Yeah.
You're really funny. Because instead of like me hearing that and going, oh, you just need extra attention because you just whatever, you were just talented. So I'm like, thanks. Fine.
What do your parents...
Say it.
What do your parents think about all this in real life? Like, what do they really think? Does your dad really call you a faggot?
No, no. They're very cool with it. They're very confused, but they're very accepting.
Yeah, they live in Knoxville, Tennessee. They're confused as shit. We don't even really know what all this means still.
They don't live in Knoxville. They live in Kingsport, Tennessee, even smaller. So.
Oh, my God.
Yeah. Whoa. How small is that?
It's like 40,000 people.
Is that one of those places you see on the Discovery Channel where they catch catfish with their hands? You ever see where they go noodling? No, they go noodling.
No,
no, no, no, no. They get in the water up to their neck. There's TV shows about it. They're amazing.
Sure, I'm sure.
They get in these like muddy water. You can't see shit up to your neck, and you reach your hand in, and these holes where these catfish live, and you grab the catfish and let it bite your arm, and then you pull them out. That's where his parents live. Are you doing that? You're not even doing that here, right? There's big catfish out there.
What do your parents do for work?
My dad, he's works at this big chemical plant, the whole reason the town is there. My mom is a physician's assistant, wow. Medical.
Oh, so they're smart people? They're intelligent people?
Yeah.
I think it's super brave that you just say it, you know? And then it's not even, you're not pandering at all. You're just being whoever you are, and you're fucking hilarious. That's what the world needs, a person who can express themselves just genuinely, where it doesn't even remotely feel performative.
Thank you.
But then your comedy's really good. So, dude, kudos. Or whatever you want me to call you. I'll go with whatever. If you're that funny, I'll call you a they.
Hey, they. It is great.
Hey, okay.
Whatever you want, man.
I've always hoped that there was more male comics that would talk
not
about being called
necessarily male. Will you shut the fuck up?
All right. I'm just going to...
Bro, check your privilege, you piece of shit. I'm so tired of these cis male assholes with cowboy hats talking shit to my non-binary friends. I mean, stop, man. Just fucking do better. Live your truth. You need to live your truth.
I do believe you're cancel proof after saying that. I think you could pretty much do any. I think you could shoot everybody in the theater.
Oh, yeah,
after
you
that.
Could kill us all and they'd blame it on your dad. And Lucas, they would go, here's money, too. Lucas, what else you want? You want to move to Mexico?
Do you have any special skills or talents or anything like that? Anything? You good at anything other than stand up comedy?
I don't think so.
Well, listen, you're really good at stand-up comedy, so fuck everything else.
How long are you in town for?
I'm living here for right now, yeah.
I'd like to invite you to the Vulcan on Thursday if you...
Wow, look at Woo! That. Lucas McCrary just got a spot at Vulcan. Woo! Congratulations, Lucas.
Does it
and,
pay?
And a great That's set. A joke. Congratulations to you. We hope you'll sign up again at one of the upcoming shows here in Austin, Texas.
Well, I got one coming up at Santa Cruz Theater May 1st. Be on the lookout. Thank you.
There you go. All right. There it is. Lucas McCrary, everybody, with a sweet, sweet plug.
Thank you.
Follow him on social media, LucasWMC. Hey, look who it is. It's Kaylee from the Yellow Rose and the Red Rose, the microphone cleaner.
Hey.
Everyone loves Kaylee. She's been switching out the microphones for us the last couple weeks at Antone's. The Yellow Rose and the Red Rose, the two premier strip clubs of Austin, Texas. And we got Kaylee from the Yellow Rose. Be careful.
Yeah.
You don't want to play with... Those are no joke. All right. Your next comedian goes by the name of Noe Lopez, everyone. Noe Lopez. Probably, yeah. Noe Lopez. I wonder if we got, coming from the back?
Do you have a countdown until you pick another person?
No, we just count to see how long they've been on stage, because sometimes, you know, we're talking to somebody and it's like, oh, wait, they've been on stage for 20 minutes. We got to get somebody else up here, you know?
Is Noe a real person?
Someone coming? Can we get house lights for just a second? You guys having fun out there, huh? Woo! Yeah, there's real people out there. Look at you guys. That's what it looks like. Here he is, everybody. Noe Lopez is here.
Woo! How's everybody doing tonight? Good? Awesome. So I used to work at a hotel as a receptionist, and one day this deaf lady comes in. And I don't know sign language, so I hand her a pen and paper so that we can communicate. Earlier in the day, I had some Mexican food, so my stomach is bubbling, and I gotta take a mean shit. Well, she can't hear, and I figured, man, I'm gonna alleviate some of the pressure, and I fucking ripped the fart. Well, did you guys know that when your senses fail, the others are heightened? I didn't know that. And this bitch must have had a fucking nose like a bloodhound, because immediately she stops writing and looks up. And I gave her the same stupid look back. And I farted again. And so I figured, fuck it, she didn't hear the other one. She's not going to hear this one. Well, you know, and she can't hear and I can deny the smell. I was like, well, I don't smell anything, whatever. Well, turns out she wasn't deaf, she was mute. She heard everything. And needless to say, she didn't book a room with us.
Noe Lopez, everybody up here talking about pooping. Hi, Noe.
How's it going, Tony?
You've been on this show before once, right?
Yeah, I followed Alomin and Darnell.
Oh, yeah. Chaos, that was. The internet found out about that today.
Yeah, that was fun.
Yeah.
I should have been here for that.
Have you seen any of what
yes, I would have grabbed Charlamagne Darnell, but like, we're going to be okay.
Everybody's been going back. We're like, I don't know if you guys know,
but
we're like the biggest show in the hip-hop community as of today. I don't know if you guys have been on Instagram at all. But
millions of views.
Charlamagne, yeah, Donnell, life. DJ Envy, all these people are all...
Donnell was just over it, but it just makes me sad. Yeah. Who's the dude?
Alomin.
He's very funny.
Golden ticket winner out of
Iowa.
He's
very funny.
Yeah.
That dude's very, very funny.
And he had no idea Donnell was going to be there. And he also...
Donnell had no idea he was going to be there either. Yeah. In all fairness.
Yeah.
That dude's just really good.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it was a powerful, powerful experience.
Donnell intoxicated?
Yes.
Yeah. He was fucked up.
Well, there you go. He couldn't consent to his own behavior.
Noe Lopez, welcome back to the show. What happened last time you were on? What happened like during the interview part? What did we find out?
That I had a felony, and apparently I gave you guys serial killer vibes.
Oh, yeah.
I was hoping you weren't going to say syphilis or some...
Yeah. What's the felony from?
Criminal mischief in 2013. I kicked the headlight on my baby mama's dad's truck.
That's criminal mischief?
Yeah, yeah. And I got a felony.
Mischief's
for that.
A hilarious word
it
for a
is,
crime.
Right?
What'd you do? Mischief?
Yeah.
Bad.
That's like a Dennis the Menace type of crime. He's up to real mischief out there.
Mischief.
Whole new thing.
Yeah.
Looking through windows and whatnot. Kicking out headlights. Real mischief.
Yeah, man. I think, yeah, like, I feel like the attention was all, like, drawn towards what had happened, like, right before I hit the stage, and so...
Oh, totally.
Oh, it's not your fault.
Yeah, okay, it's never your fault, bro. And I bombed whatever, but, like, yeah, it was rough, I'm not going to lie.
How long have you been doing stand-up comedy?
This is my second time.
Your second time ever, so you've only done Kill Tony. You've
only done
two
Tony.
Sets,
yeah.
You've done 2 minutes
When was
minutes
the last
total?
Time you did it before?
For episode 499, this was roughly, what, 3 weeks ago?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Do you really want to do this? Is that
Hell
what you
yeah.
want to do?
I'll be honest, man. I've always wanted to be a comedian, but I didn't have the balls to do it. A 5-minute open mic set to me seems intimidating, more intimidating than this. And I figured, man, if I'm going to fucking bomb, I'll bomb here on Kill Tony. Why not?
Mm. Yeah, well, maybe you should try to do good. There's this whole other approach that you could have.
I'm trying.
Why don't you go bomb at open mics and do good here?
I got to do open mics, though.
Here's the thing. You can't just do it twice. You know?
Yeah.
Yeah.
And because it's just too hard. And when you're doing it twice and both times you're doing it in front of the whole world.
Yeah.
Like, the whole world's not going to watch, but they could.
Yeah.
They all could.
I get it.
That's crazy, right?
Yeah.
You shouldn't be starting out like that.
Yeah.
The show's a terrible idea. I'm a big fan of it.
No,
but it's also like, I don't want to jump, do flips with a dirt bike.
I think what it was is like, I figured I can put together a minute, you know?
But can you?
Yeah, but let them decide.
Here's the thing, man. You can't do it that way. There's no way.
Understood.
It's like I want to run marathons. Well, do you run at all? No, I'm saving myself.
Right.
Same for myself, for the one time.
I've only run.
I got to run 26 miles in a row. That's what you just said.
I've only run twice in my life. It was for 60 seconds each and a few weeks in between.
And they watched on the internet.
I want to start hitting the open mics. My intention is to hit up the open mics.
No,
it's too hard, man. Yeah. Anybody in this room that's a professional that's gone on, if we had to do it the first time ever on this stage, it's the hardest environment on earth. There's people behind you. That's very weird. Like, we're behind you talking shit, and you're up here like this. And all these people, and the internet. It's terrible. Get out of here, man. Don't do this.
What's the funniest thing you've ever done, like, in your life, where you made a bunch of people laugh, or your coworkers, or what do you do for work?
I work in a warehouse.
Okay, there you go. Perfect opportunity to make a bunch of people laugh. What'd you do?
I don't know. I couldn't tell you off the top of my head.
How about your family? Anything with your family? Do you remember making your family laugh? Or perhaps a classroom of students?
I just have a knack for saying.
I don't like the way this prosecutor is interrogating my witness.
Thank you, Joe.
We're trying to get to the bottom of this case.
Objection leading.
You're putting a lot of pressure on him.
Answer the question.
I can't. I can't think of one thing.
As your attorney, I advise you to tell him to go fuck himself. Outrageous behavior.
Objection.
Imagine you being on stage the second time ever. All of them are on the internet.
Hey, this is what he signs up for.
I understand, but all bullshit aside, you just got to do open mic nights, man.
Yes, sir.
You got to get out and just go do them everywhere, every time you can. And even if you don't want to do it, you're like, oh my God, there's five people here. I can't do this. Just do it. Do it. Keep doing it. And eventually you look back and laugh or not. Yeah. That can happen too. It's like everything. It's hard, but it can be done, you know?
Cool. When you bought that hat, did you think you were going to have magical comedian powers?
Because it works for Joe.
Bro, are you shitting on my hat while you're wearing a fucking cowboy hat?
Dude.
It's a comedian hat.
Only comedians wear that hat.
Fuck you, man.
It's like when you see a baseball player
with a
hard batting helmet on. It's like that guy's about to go to bat.
It's comedians and aging punk rockers.
When we did that at End of the World party and Bill Burr said it was a paper boy. What did he say? Little Rascals
hat. I never heard that.
That's hilarious.
The imagery is crazy because it's such a mirror image. You were talking about farting during your set. I was like, this is a Mexican red band. And here we are.
Yeah. It's a brown band. Noe Lopez. What does the word Noe mean? It's such a rare name.
What the fuck are you talking about?
Noe?
That's a normal Mexican name. You racist piece of shit.
Oh.
I'm back.
It's a biblical name.
What?
It's Noah. Like in the Bible, the Spanish translation, it's Noe is Noah, but it's pronounced Noe.
Okay. So you're named after Noah, basically.
Yeah.
Oh, has to fix that boat.
Yeah.
Jesus.
Exactly.
Mexicans are the only people that can name their kid Jesus.
Yeah.
That's true.
Imagine if you're like a regular white guy, even if you love Jesus.
But they don't. They name him.
You can't name your fucking kid Jesus. They're like,
nah, I can't do it.
But if you're Mexican, they're like, how do you say it?
How about you? You have any special skills or talents?
I am actually a musician, and I have a reggae band. I play piano, guitar, bass, and drums. I do it decently.
Are you better at that than comedy?
I am, man.
Probably.
I would say I'm pretty good.
But you know that you can do that. So if you got better at that, you can get better at comedy. It's the same thing. It's like anything you do, whether you're doing music or art, or it's just how much time do you spend trying to analyze what you're doing wrong.
You sing?
Oh, shit. I sing my songs.
Yeah,
we sing Happy Birthday to Tony as if he's John F. Kennedy, you're Marilyn Monroe.
No. Don't do
please,
that.
Please.
Don't do it.
Come on,
no,
man.
No, don't do it. Don't
it's your 500th episode.
No, I don't want him to sound like Marilyn Monroe.
Happy birthday, Mr. President.
I want to hear him sing in his real voice. I want to see if this guy's good at anything.
Now you're getting mean.
I know, yeah. I'm about to get
mean. I'm appealing to the 10% of you that's gay, and you're getting uncomfortable.
Happy birthday.
Do it.
It's not even my birthday.
It's 500 episodes.
Come on, him doing his best Marilyn Monroe impression.
No, I want to hear him sing a song that you actually wrote. Like,
why are you trying to kill all the fun, Tony?
God damn it. Sing me happy birthday like Marilyn Monroe, you piece of shit.
No.
Want to stand around there. God damn it. Now do it.
As your attorney, I won't let him talk to you this way. I advise you to use the fifth.
Sing a fucking song, Noe Lopez. Sing fucking anything.
Can I use your band?
Yeah, do whatever you want.
Oh, my God, we're getting down right now. I feel like Noe's going to blow us away, and we're going to say stop with the comedy.
Whoa.
Oh, here he goes.
What is happening?
Noe!
La, 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 bamba. Oh, shit, it is. Oh, that was John.
No, he's legit.
I ain't got the time. Can't always be by your side. And I don't get much sympathy for who I choose to be. But you know I try. Girl, you know I try. Girl, you know I try. Lord knows I try.
Wow. Look at that. Noe, guess who never gets to do stand-up comedy again?
Noe, listen, man. You need a guidance counselor.
Yeah. Will you be
I'm
going to
be your guidance
counselor.
Yeah. You're a fucking great musician. Like, that was great. The fact that just came out of nowhere, you didn't prepare for that. We just talked to you, and then all of a sudden you grabbed the guitar. That was a beautiful moment, man. That was fun.
I wrote that. That's my song.
Yeah. That was a beautiful moment. That was very
cool. You could literally ask anybody if you should stop being a musician and become a stand-up comedian, and everyone would say, Noe. Noe, Noe, Noe,
Noe, Noe.
There he goes, everybody. The stylings of Noe Lopez, his second ever comedy set. First time playing music on this show. That was pretty cool.
How cool was that moment?
How amazing is this band? John Dees on the keys. D Madness, Michael Gonzalez, Kaylee, the Yellow Rose and the Red Rose, Partner Clubs, there she is, a Stone Cold Assassin, Zach Bogus just got fired.
Who did?
Zach who?
You will never see Zach Bogus again. It's our helper. Seriously, check out the Yellow Rose and the Red Rose.
Yeah. Check out these hats they gave us. Ooh. Titty 69. Fuck yeah.
Let's get another one up here. Here we go. Zach Stankto Robbins. Uh-oh.
Homie's got a nickname.
Stankto is in the house. This is interesting.
Look who's over there painting also in the...
Oh, yeah. Chris Rogers art. There he is. The local Austin artist.
Yeah, he's... painting in the...
Follow him on the Instagram.
Close friend of the band.
Chris Rogers Art at Chris Rogers Art.
Yep.
And how often does he do this?
Almost every show. And then he does every secret show also.
Last night?
Yeah. And then he sells the painting at the end. Yeah. You know, it's really great.
Not to
Bernie
be confused
Mac
with Ryan J. Ebelt, who draws all the tour posters and every episode of the show for 6 years.
There's
we got
so
Zach
much
Stankto.
Art going on, man.
Yeah. And here
coming
comes
from the audience.
More. Ladies and gentlemen... going all the way around. Okay, that's not the right way. Zach Stankto Robbins, everybody. One more time for Zach.
Yeah, my friends do call me Stankto. And even though I'm called Stankto, I'm not into feet. So the only toes I suck on are camel toes. It's true, it's happened before. You ever have a girl ask you for a dick pic, and so later you're scrolling through your phone, have to look at your own ugly-ass penis? It's like, gross. I'm just kidding. Nobody has to see my dick. I just keep sending it anyway. Y'all ever see a grown-ass man, and everywhere he goes, he has a fucking backpack on? Yeah, that dude's either autistic or he sells drugs. And if he's not autistic... Me and that motherfucker going to the ATM machine later. What you got in that bag, bro?
There he is. Zach Stanktoe Robbins has arrived to the show. Zach, you've been on this show before as well, correct?
Yeah, March 1st, about 5 weeks ago.
We had a lot of fun, right?
I sure as fuck did.
Yeah, what happened? Remind me.
I did 8 jokes in 1 minute. Y'all told me to slow down. We found out my wife left, you know.
Oh, yeah.
I love you know.
And then the younger,
you know, after young, something
my
crazy
younger
like
girlfriend
that.
Also dumped me in this recently within
you know.
6 months.
All so, these
you know.
Women leaving you for a guy that sucks on camel toes. You would think you'd be able to keep them around a little bit longer. When you say you suck on camel toes, do you mean, because a camel toe is very famously an indentation over, like under, through the pants.
Oh, so, I know what it is.
So you suck on vaginas through pants?
That's a really good question.
I'm just not into feet, so those are the only toes I'm into, I guess. I don't
but it's a, first of all, it's singular. It's a camel toe. No girl has camel toes unless you're sucking on multiple girls' camel toes through the outside of their pants. Technically, once you lose the pants and the underwear, there's no more camel toe. That's just a pussy.
It's like the, it must be the dry humping of eating pussy then.
Do you hear what he's saying to you though?
like
there's wisdom in his words. You just gotta take it in.
Yeah.
And go, oh, I see what I'm doing wrong.
Yeah.
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 You're supposed to take the wrapper off the burrito. I get it.
Hey, there you go.
That's not bad right there.
You go. You're getting
now you're
there.
On the right track.
Yeah.
Now we're all comfortable and everybody's laughing together.
Yeah.
100%. This is real important.
100%.
This is a big part of the formula.
Once you remove that wrapper out of off those burritos, I bet the ladies don't leave you quite as much. Once you start eating actual pussy instead of their fucking zipper.
Chipping all your teeth.
My man's driving a car from the roof.
Zach, what do you do for work? You seem like a guy that has a real job.
I do. I'm a professional videographer. For sports, music, and comedy.
Oh, cool.
And
I filmed Steve-O's comedy special right here on
the
stage.
Oh, he got you high, and here we are. That's what happened.
He was sober.
Then. Yeah, he's sober.
I love it. How long have you been doing stand-up?
4 months now.
4 months. What made you want to start now?
I just actually wish I would have done it a long time ago. So.
How nervous are you now compared to regular life?
I mean... I'm pretty comfortable on stage. I've been
right
hitting
now?
Shitloads of mics. So.
But you like seemed to like get more comfortable when we were talking to you. And then when we were going back and forth, then it was real fun, right? Like relaxing that. It's you got to figure out how to get there immediately.
Right.
Like right when you get on stage, you got to be who you are when you're with your friends and everybody's laughing. You can get there, but it's complicated, right? But this is the worst environment ever for it. I'm the worst... spokesperson for Kill Tony ever. I'm like, don't do it. This is terrible. You doing stand up?
I'm just
you
trying
don't even
not
know
to
what
move my
saying.
Feet like last time because Sarah was like, you're crip walking up here. It's distracting. So I'm
you
just
crip
trying...
walk?
That's good.
No, I just kept moving my feet last time.
Yeah, he was very, right. very nervous. Tell us something interesting about your life that we didn't find out last time you were on.
I forgot to mention that I used to smoke heroin for breakfast for about 5 years.
Oh, that's why you're eating camel toes.
I get it. It's like one molecule off.
Yeah.
Do you ever shoot it up or just smoke it?
Smoking and snorting, I never really shot up. But
when you say you never really shot
addict,
up,
so.
When you say you never really, because I never really shot up.
No, you've never shot
but
up.
But I would never say that I never really shot up. I would say yeah. I've never shot up.
That's
what
like,
what the
I've
fuck?
Never really sucked a dick. But there was this fucking crazy day.
No,
I don't want to get into it.
I never sucked a dick because he still had his pants on. See?
Yes!
Hey, there you
see?
Go.
See,
there
right
is.
There, man.
There
that's
it is.
It. That's it.
That's it.
That's the spot you want to get to more often.
Hell yeah. That is it.
That was very funny, dude.
3 years, 2 months, and a week and a half sober, though, so that's good.
I love it.
All right, well, there you go. That's the rest of the explanation.
We have good news for you.
Heroin sober.
We have a giveaway. We have a heated.
Oh, you're heroin sober?
Yeah, it's like California sober.
What does that mean? Do you smoke weed?
I don't
weed?
Do heroin, but.
Do you smoke weed?
I do.
How
I
much
do
weed?
How do you much
eat
you
it?
Got?
Do you eat it?
Huh?
Yeah, I'm pretty
if
sure.
If you eat weed, bitch, you are not sober. Do you eat weed? Yeah, yeah.
I actually smoke so much weed, edibles don't do that much to me.
They all say that until you give them the right dose.
I mean.
You ever take weed and heat it up on a spoon and then inject it into your veins?
Jesus.
Ouch.
I got some dabs in my truck. I mean, that's the correct.
Because I never really have done that.
You never really shot up? Did you really shoot up?
You y'all trying? You don't want to hear the truth or what?
Yeah, dude.
Okay, I never straight shot it into my vein, but I did like insulin and like would do the butt cheek, but also didn't like needles around, so I just quit doing that.
So when you did that, how did it make you feel?
High as fuck. But I also snorted it and smoked it and shot.
Why are you so defensive about these injections?
Because he wants another hit.
Yeah, you're getting him itchy, bro.
I got money.
Right. You ever do anything crazy to get your fix for heroin? Fix, by the way, is the official sponsor of the band, Fix Vodka.
That's right.
But you ever do anything crazy to get your fix? You ever,
suck a dick with the pants on?
Like tell yourself you're not going to do drugs today, and then you kind of black out, and then you wake up at the pawn shop with your bass amp, like, $50 is $50, bro.
All right.
Huh.
Is there anything that helps you stay sober?
I just came out and told my friends and family, and they're holding me accountable. I also know that I won't get to smoke the weed and drink beer if I relapse again, and that's all I got, man.
I love it. That's sort of a good way of looking at it.
It seems like you're flying in the face of all those 12-step people.
I never even went to one meeting.
But isn't that interesting? Like, there's other ways to do it then. That's what you're saying.
I was also trying to quit on my own. I was done with it. I didn't want to do it anymore. I was starting to not pay bills. I was about to lose my career, and I have an awesome job. I was like, no.
Well, good for you, man. Good for you.
You did it.
You're obviously, when you get loose, all bullshit aside before we move on to the next person, when you get loose, you're very funny. You're funny. We had a good time, right?
Yep, 100%.
It's hard, dude. This is not the way to do it. Kill Tony's a terrible way to start up.
It's the first time we've had a guest. That just
I love this show. Don't get me wrong.
Very special episode tonight.
Very fucking special.
I love watching Bull Riders.
Thank you.
I watch Bull Riders a lot.
Zach, what's really interesting is that you were just on the show a few weeks ago, and you clearly are. I mean, we were making fun of you moving your feet a lot, fidgeting continuously. Already, whatever happened to you up here a few weeks ago at Antone's mentally changed you. You're much calmer, more comfortable.
Yeah, so, Jamar Neighbors heckled the fuck out of me, bro.
He did what?
Jamar Neighbors heckled the fuck out of me. It was great. Oh.
Yeah, you probably deserved it.
Then he said my
it.
Jokes were lit, so.
There you go. Zach Stanktoe Robbins, everybody. He's on Instagram at Stanktoe Claruso. There he goes. All right.
That's a good. That guy's a good example.
Yeah.
Don't you think?
Yeah.
A good example of a person.
Guys, how about a big hand for Kaylee, everyone? Look at this. You know what? Before we go back to the bucket, let's get another regular up here. You guys want to see another regular on Kill Tony? Ladies and gentlemen, this guy. Absolute brilliant joke writer. Brilliant roaster. Ladies and gentlemen, he's here all the way from Los Angeles, California. Another big bonus for you. It's the great David Lucas, everybody. Here we go. Here we go.
Yeah, what's up, y'all? I do intermittent fasting now. I don't eat till 2 p.m., but the problem is I wake up at 1:50. So I start eating within 10 minutes of waking up. Ain't that a bitch? I've been watching a lot of motivational videos. I watch Eric Thomas, who's like the black Tony Robbins. And motivational videos never give you thorough instructions. Like, Eric Thomas gets on YouTube every morning. He's like, you got to wake up at 5 a.m. 5 a.m. is the magic number. You got to get up at 5 a.m. And then I wake up at 5 and I'm like, nigga, what's next? Like, should I fucking cook? Like, should I make some eggs and bacon? Like, nigga, you didn't give me no thorough instructions. Like, you just told me to wake up at 5. I guess I'll watch this video tomorrow. All right, guys, thank you.
Yeah, David Lucas.
Yeah.
Veteran of the game.
Yeah, man.
Here he is, episode 500.
Can I just say, when you guys face off, whenever I've been on this show,
we're already
laughing. You guys are like looking at each other like two dudes at a weigh-in. Here we go, bitch. Ready? You ain't ready.
It is. Luckily for David, this is not a weigh-in.
Hey, Tony dressed like he about to do stand-in work for Brokeback Mountain 2.
Oh, my God. You look like you're about to do work for Broke Knees Mountain. Look at this guy.
Yeah, yeah. Get your Indiana Mike Jones-looking ass up out of here.
You dress like you're about to shoot up insulin. Got a new blazer?
Tony, you work at a ranch. You help horses get a hard dick.
You totally ignored my blazer setup.
Fuck that blazer setup, nigga.
Where'd you go to get that? Big and Fat? I love it, though. They match the shoes. You truly are colored coordinated.
Racist.
That's a 2022 joke coming out a little bit early. It's like a car. Sometimes car models come out before they should. That's a 2022 right there.
The only horse you ride is a gay nigga dressed up as one.
Your style of roasting is my absolute favorite. Just straight up funny shit, not necessarily smart at all. Just straight fucking funny. Like I'm riding a guy dressed like a horse. But then again, honestly, the funny thing is, that was almost how the episode tonight started. I almost had the people wear one of those double horse outfits. And It was pitched in the writer's room.
Y'all can't see him, but Tony got on chaps with nothing under it.
The only thing chapped on you are your elbows. I'm not telling you. This is not a joke. A real gunslinger tonight.
The kid's the undisputed king.
Is that a pistol filled with glitter and toenail clippings? Hey, when Tony shoot that pistol, the word pow pops out.
Oh, my God, David. Welcome to episode 500,
goddamn
sir.
Right.
Another rock solid minute, another fun time. What else is happening?
Shit, bro. Just been chilling in Austin. You know what I'm saying? Finally found a place I'm going to move to.
Look at that. Moving to Austin. Yeah, hello.
Yeah.
Absolutely. He did. He's moving to a table at Matt's El Rancho. Finally found a place. Table 39.
Tony's complaint about Austin is that too many people leave the toilet seat up.
That's actually true. I've been yelping a lot of places. I fall in every time. I don't have to. Not all of us are physically impossible to fall into a toilet. You can't even slide it into a bathtub how I fall into a toilet. David just dips his feet in it.
Tony, your skinny ass, you look like you take baths in shot glasses.
You fall in the toilet seat with the toilet seat down also, right?
Yeah, it's true. It's true. It's very easy for me. And the weird thing is that that's just when I'm standing up peeing. I just dive in. Like, I just straight just... Yeah, that doesn't make any sense.
If you stand up and pee, you get charged with a misdemeanor.
Whatever. David, what have you been doing in town? What have you been eating? Anything good?
By the way,
you are gaining weight, I must say. It's one of my favorite things. If you're wondering what it's like being me and watching friends that I make fun of gain weight, it's like you checking your GameStop stock to find out you're rich. I love it. It means business is booming. You just keep gaining, David. No one wants to make fun of a skinny David Lucas.
Fuck no. Fuck no. Hell no. I ate at that QI restaurant. I don't know how you say it. It's an Asian restaurant. Q Chi Ki. Yeah, there you go. And I ate at an Asian spot right here on 6th Street. It's like Wuhan or some shit. Wu Chow. Oh, there we go. Yeah.
That's my friend CK's place.
Today?
Yes.
Wu Chow's the shit. You ever eaten here?
Uh-huh.
No?
Yeah,
oh, my God.
Good.
It's amazing. Chinese food.
Wu Chow's legit.
Yeah, that shit good, bro.
Did finally find my new favorite pizza place in Austin. It's called, I think it's a Via 313. Is that a thing? Wow. Okay.
Austin has some fucking amazing food.
Oh, yeah.
That is absolutely true.
Yeah.
That's undeniable. There might be more good restaurants in Austin than there are in L.A.
I agree. Totally agree.
Absolutely.
I swear to God.
Legitimately. That's not bullshit.
I already have my two favorite sushi places are here.
Sushi ATX, number one.
Yeah. I don't want to rile up people in L.A. But fuck you, man. I thought you liked us.
Oh, yeah. I'm positive. I'm positive Austin has better food than L.A. And I lived in L.A. for 14 years, and I've lived here for, what, 3 or 4 months, and I'm positive this place has better
more
food
butter
than
and cheese also. Everything tastes better.
It's all.
It's just, you guys have a fucking dope city.
Yeah.
You really do. You have a crazy city.
It's true.
It was a no-brainer moving here.
And you're right. There's a lot of butter, a lot of cheese, a lot of salt, and that's just David Lucas. I love it, David. So you're moving here.
Yeah.
I love it.
Yeah. Hey, what's up, Shotty?
Oh, shit. Wow.
That was beautiful. There was no pause between her and him.
I got the white girls on lock in Austin.
Oh, shit. Damn. Wow. What do you do? Look through their drive-through window? Just peeking through.
That was good. I like that one.
Real peeping slob. I love it. I love what's going on. I love it. What else, David? Anything else before we let you go?
That's about it. Just been doing shows. Did the Death Squad show. It was lit. Mm-hmm. Joe was up there. You was up there. Redman was up there. Killed it. That's about it, bro. Going to what water hole am I going to tomorrow? I'm going to Sculpture Falls tomorrow.
Oh, shit. Yeah. What's
that? How did you know where he's going?
That's my boy up there.
You're going to a watering hole?
Yeah.
Man, you're more like an elephant than I thought. Thank you, God. Thank you, God, for that one. I mean, what a setup.
Out of all the years I've seen you, this might be your crowning moment.
I mean, what a setup.
This night might be Tony Hinchcliffe's crowning moment.
Bro.
No bullshit. This is a set where if I saw this in a movie, I'd be like, shut the fuck up. that shit didn't just come out of nowhere. They scripted that. They're like 50 writers.
What are you going to do with the watering hole, though? Seriously.
Swim.
You're going to swim?
I can swim.
Oh, my God. Are you going to?
You were talking about a bar.
No, it's a real
when you said the watering hole, I'm like.
Jet Ski Johnson.
Are we in cowboy days?
You and your white girl are going to look like Timon and Pumbaa out there.
You and your white girl are going to look like Timon and Pumbaa.
What is Timon and Pumbaa?
Lion King, never heard of it, Joe
Rogan?
I didn't know the reference.
It's from The Lion King.
It's
you think I watched that bullshit?
Watch it. Believe me, you'll love it.
The Lion King?
Oh, yeah.
Probably won't.
You've never seen the lion?
Are you joking?
What, lions that talk?
Oh, no.
What? Am I, a baby?
No. Holtzman's favorite movie.
Joking. Yeah, I know. Oh. This guy's heckling me from the back. One of the guitarists doesn't get what's going on. I'm joking.
David.
I have to watch the fucking Lion King. I have kids.
Right.
But I'm like, where's his dick? What are we doing?
Yeah, maybe
we're pretending they talk and they don't have dicks? What is this?
Right.
What are you teaching my kids?
It's not about their penises.
Everybody dies. There's no blood. No one has a dick. What are we doing?
That's the number one thing you
Where are they
of?
Getting their food? The fuck are you showing my children? Right.
So would you want them to have dicks?
Yes! Big fat dicks. They're lions. They're killing water buffaloes with their face.
So do they just watch porn?
All right.
Don't lions only fuck for like 90 seconds?
It's not that long, but they do it a lot.
Yeah.
They can fuck 52 times in a day.
God damn.
Yeah. When the female tiger is in season, the male tiger will fuck her 52 times a day. Lions is like slightly less.
Okay, so it's just not realistic enough for you. in general. The Lion King.
The Lion King. Yeah. Thank you. You
it's
understand
fake.
Where I'm
it's,
coming from,
it's
right?
It's fake. It's a cartoon. Yeah.
No, I've watched it, but, you know, I have to talk to my kids afterwards. I go, listen, liberals want to pretend that the world is not exactly what it is. They're soft people. They live in soft little houses. They nerf every fucking corner. They're not going to make it. When shit gets weird, they're not going to make it. My kid's crying. I'm like, I know you're four, but one day this is going to make sense.
David Lucas, you did it again. Yeah, another brand new killer minute. A lot of fun roasting. Unbelievable. David Lucas, everybody. Monster. Another one moving to Austin, Texas. It's a really big deal.
No bullshit, Tony. The two of you together should be on a fucking... You should be doing that, like, everywhere.
Yeah.
Because I don't know if you will run dry.
No.
You guys talk so much shit to each other.
Oh,
I don't
yeah.
know if you'll run dry.
Every time something new happens in the news, I ask myself, how can I turn this into a fat joke about David Lucas? And when I figured out that DMX one, I mean, I'm serious. I purposefully didn't tell anyone.
Listen.
I didn't tell anybody because I wanted there to be no way that I could ruin it. Your next comedian goes by the name of Adam Kamal. K-A-M-A-L. This is exciting. Adam Kamal. I wonder if he's coming from the audience. I like it when they come from the crowd. There's an alleyway filled with, I think, like, I don't know, 20, 30 comedians that couldn't get a ticket. Because their thumbs aren't as quick as yours on the internet.
There's an odd sense of chaos in this room.
Yeah.
Right? Like, this could all go sideways.
Oh, yeah.
Feels episode like- 500. I feel like there if we is. Never... Here he comes.
One more time for Adam Kamal.
What the fuck is up, guys? Hell yeah, hell yeah. I'm Middle Eastern, and I think wearing a beard is a good look. I often like to compare it with a flannel, too. A lot of my friends like to call me a Middle Eastern lumberjack. The thing about calling me a Middle Eastern lumberjack is that instead of cutting trees down, you know, we cut down towers instead. Listen, dude, listen, okay? I drink beer, I eat pork, I have unprotected sex. I'm part of you, all right? Like, lumberjacks, you know what they do? They harvest wood. And, you know, they make trees out, or they make paper out of it. They fucking make furniture out of it. You might be thinking, what do terrorists get out of fucking bombing towers, right? Well, we're just building a funnel and pipeline filled with ripe hymens. I'm talking 72 virgins in heaven. You know what I mean? Like, God has a promotion for you. All right, that's my time, guys. Thank you so much. Appreciate it.
I can't Adam Kamal.
This is fucking crazy, dude.
Yeah.
This is insane.
Joe Rogan, 59 seconds in your set, Joe Rogan pulled out a joint and said, I think I need to get high. It was a very sobering
I need
set.
A refresh.
Yeah. Oh, that set was truly an act of terrorism. I mean, that was... Oh, you have hijacked the show and... You've locked the captain out of the cabin, it appears. Welcome to the show, Adam Kamal.
What's up, Tony?
I'm guessing you cut that last name short.
Yeah, my original last name is like Abu Harthia, which means father of Harthia.
Jesus Christ. When you cut your name short, did you do it by beheading it sideways with a sword? Or
I sharpened a knife before, too.
Okay. Okay, go ahead. What does your last name mean?
It just means, like, Father Abu, and in Harthia, I come from, like, a farming family from Bethlehem, so.
Oh, wow. Bethlehem.
Yes, sir.
The birthplace of?
Jesus.
Right.
Yeah.
You ever, like, go?
Allegedly.
You ever go back there and see, like, Jesus stuff?
No,
you ever visit?
I've been to Jordan. I kind of grew up all over. Mm-hmm. The closest I've been to the Middle East is just living in Dubai. But aside from that, yeah, I've never really been over there.
Okay.
Yeah.
But you visited Jordan.
Yes, sir.
Right.
Yeah.
Named after the great Montel Jordan.
Yeah.
Those of you that don't know, it's Friday night and I feel all right.
Yeah.
What kind of car do you drive? I imagine you drive like a really nice car and have like a
like
tiger.
Like a Honda with a fat muffler.
And a tiger in the back seat or
I
something.
I do drive a Honda Civic.
Whoa. Yeah.
Called it.
Hell yeah.
Does it go...
No, I'm pretty... No, I'm okay with myself, you know?
You're okay with yourself?
Yeah, I don't need to like...
So what are you saying? People. Asian people have an issue with Hondas, with the mufflers?
Yo, I did live in Asia and all I could you just see like...
The whole continent?
Yeah.
I lived in Kuala Lumpur.
Did you have a specific spot? What?
Kuala Lumpur.
Ah, all right.
Yeah.
We don't really consider that Asia. Yeah. You know what I mean? That's like the that's the Hawaii of Asia.
It's more like a resort, right?
Yeah. Right? Isn't it very nice there?
No, it's nice. It's like a vacation spot. People come over there.
Right.
It's
there's
really
no
cheap.
Fucking diseases breaking out in laboratories there. It's not real Asia. Right. I mean, that's not fucking the heartland.
No.
Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
What do you do for work?
I'm in sales.
What are you selling?
I sell like any
Coke.
I wish.
You wish? We can make it happen.
We'll talk after the show, right? No, I do. Like we sell like IV drips, hyperbarics, things like that.
You sell IV drips?
Yeah.
How do you do that? Like on the street? Well,
I wish.
Like, hey man, how's your energy level?
We you know we're eco-friendly. We reuse the needles, you know. But no. No, basically I work for a company. I just develop a bunch of stores around the country, and we just help people, like, you know, do a bunch of stuff that Joe Rogan likes, you know?
Jesus, dude. Yeah. I mean, what the... He's sitting right here. Adam, you have any special skills or talents? Anything you do for fun other than stand-up, like a hobby? Something you got good at?
I mean, I just work out, and, like, I just try to make money on the side.
You work out, make money on the side?
Yes, sir.
What the fuck?
Are you a gay hooker?
What kind of answer is that? What do you mean you work out and make money on the side?
I mean,
what do you do for fun? What are you good at?
I go out. You know, I do comedy.
You go out, you're good at going out.
Yeah, you know?
Yeah.
Most of the times dudes go out and they don't know what they're doing.
You like dance? You dance?
They're just tripping in the fucking streets.
You go to like nightclubs and dance?
No, I just like bars, like live music, stuff like that.
So when live music's playing, you don't dance?
Any kind of live
bit.
Music.
You dance a little bit? Let's see what his dancing's like. I want to see some good old Middle Eastern dancing. Let's see, you guys got something dialed up for our friend Adam Akbar? Oh, shit. Uh-oh. Oh, shit. Oh, that was it. I was waiting for you to pull the fuse out or something
that. Right, just end the show in a bang, right?
Pull the fuse out?
Yeah, it didn't make sense.
I thought it was a tampon joke.
Light a fuse or, yeah.
You guys couldn't see, but the stripper is going crazy backstage.
Damn it.
Adam, what are your parents
as opposed
like?
To what?
Your parents very like reserved, very religious people?
Yeah. I mean I had to come out here just kind of like open up, be more kind of just open-minded about stuff.
Is there any joke where they're like, Adam, no?
Yeah, I mean, my parents didn't really accept me like doing comedy until I got like a full-time job. You know, they kind of just like laugh at you. Just like how Fahim said he was like an engineer and like his dad wasn't really approving of it. Same thing for us. It's kind of like hard getting out of that. But aside from that, yeah, they're starting to like open up more to it.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Mm. What's the best time you've ever had on stage? Has there been like one time where it all came together and it made sense?
Yeah, man. I just moved here. I started in Dallas. I've been doing it for 9 months. And I had a show at Hyenas. And I just like, I had a pretty shitty week. And I just fucking did really well. And like,
you got in the groove.
Yeah. I ran like a couple miles before the show. I felt great.
Mm.
Went on there. I had a lot of good energy. And, you know, it felt great. It felt good. So
even if you're lying to me, I like what you're saying. It's like I ran miles before the show. He might have just did a couple of sit-ups.
Yeah.
I love it, Adam. Well, 9 months in the game, you're Middle Eastern. You're talking about it. You're fucking doing it. You cut your name shorter so that you sound more Americanized.
Yes,
and it surprises people when you come up and you're all like, la, 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 or whatever it was that you did up here. And
Tony.
That's exciting stuff, Adam.
I'm going to need a red band buffer between you and me from now on.
I sit on the other side. Adam, fun times, man. Congratulations on getting pulled. We'll see you again soon. There goes Adam Kamal, everybody. There you go. Your next comedian is going to be Justin Sanford. While the mic's getting cleaned, Justin Sanford. That's right. Follow Kaylee, by the way. You can go see her at the Yellow Rose. Sometimes
Red
the
Rose.
Red Rose.
At the Red Rose.
Follow her on social media at kaylee.funk73. kaylie.funk.73. How about a hand for Kaylee, everybody, yes. Helping us out. Somebody's got to do it. Much better her than Zach Bogus. Justin Sanford is still next on Kill Tony. Hopefully he's making his way to the stage. This is a really big venue. How about a big hand for the band, everyone, playing hard for us here tonight. Michael Gonzalez, Jetski Johnson, D Madness, John Dees, and Matt Muehling. Wish you would step back from that ledge, my friend.
They're coming up right there from the
there
audience.
There he is. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for Justin Sanford, everyone.
How's everyone doing? Stopped to get a haircut on the way here, but my barbershop wasn't open, so I had to go to the Puerto Rican barbershop down the road. And I'm from Texas. I speak Spanish, but I don't know what language they were speaking. So finally get in the chair, tell them I want a low fade. I was there for about an hour and 45 minutes. Haircut only took 45 minutes, but he was driving me like I was that 96 Mustang he had out the parking lot. You know, the one with the little Puerto Rican flag. So sitting there grinding through my head, shifting gears, not hitting the clutch, grinding second, third, missed fourth, put it in reverse. I said, hey, man, we're not in a rush. Calm down. So, 45 minutes, done. But for the next hour, he stands there spinning me around, stepping back, looking at me, walking over with the razor blade, hiding, coming back. Finally, he steps outside, has him open the door, lights a cigarette, looks at me, comes in and goes, okay, Papa, from here up, you're good. From here down, I can't help you.
All right, Justin Sanford, setting it up and then knocking it down at the end. Welcome. You look like you just got off a bus from Miami.
Thank you.
All right.
Port Arthur.
You always dress like that? You always dress like your, like, own stepson or something?
Yes, sir.
He looks like he's, like, inmate one in the unexpected COVID-19 release where they sent a bunch of people back out in the streets.
Yeah, he's got neck tattoos. I can see him from here.
Do you like that?
That looks like inmate shit.
What do your neck tattoos say? What do you got on you?
Pair of clippers.
Oh, are you, you're a barber?
Slash barber slash tattoo removal.
Okay. Slash. You just remove tattoos. You don't
slash
make them.
What else?
Hey, whatever, bro.
Can we keep going with that?
Nah, I don't want to.
People are hustling. How's business going right now in the barber tattoo removal world?
Pretty good.
Yeah, good. You're here in Austin?
Yeah, staying at the Stephen F. Austin Hotel right here in the corner.
Okay, where do you normally live?
Port Arthur, Texas.
Port Arthur, Texas. Now tell us something about Port Arthur. I keep learning about all these.
Janis Joplin's from there. Bum B.
Janis Joplin's from there?
Yes, sir.
Wow. Damn.
Oh, shit. My wife has a tattoo of her on her arm, like, you know.
Ooh, okay. I like you more now.
Yeah, and you probably got to see her live, right?
No, man, I'm not that damn old.
How dare you?
It's fun. It's only fun for me to make fun of a guy for being old if he dresses young. You know what I mean? Like, if he dressed his age, I wouldn't even be doing these jokes.
How old are you?
38.
38? Whoa, 38. Let's talk about your recent meth addiction. Let's do it, bro. Let's be honest, man. You've done some partying. Either that or you have been stressed for 36 years.
Are you the president?
My kids say I'm permanently angry, but I just have no serotonin, I don't think.
Really? Is that what it is?
Yeah.
You were never, like, really a party animal?
I partied a little bit.
Wait a minute. You don't have any serotonin?
Yeah, I naturally.
How do you know this?
Talking to the mic.
How do I know it?
Yes.
I smoke too much. So, you know, it doesn't make it naturally. I have to get it from that.
No. Have you gone to a doctor?
No, I don't have no insurance, man.
So where is this serotonin diagnosis coming from? Jesus?
Yeah, no. Nah, I'm just listening to shit, you know.
Podcasts?
Podcasts.
Don't
do
it.
A lot of you.
Bro, podcasts are bullshit. Don't do that.
How many kids do you have?
Four.
Four kids? Oh, shit, dude. What are their ages?
12 to 16.
Do you have any kids that are older than you?
No.
I need to know. Because I'm trying to piece this puzzle together with tricks.
You have four kids?
Yes, sir.
And you said 12 and 16?
12, 2, 6, 13, 14, 15, 16.
Whoa, you went on a rampage.
No cable.
Your condom budget ran out or something, huh? 4 years.
I started paying for the cable bills.
Jesus Christ, bro.
That's why you look like that.
You should start coming what on happened? Your face and rubbing it into your skin or something like that.
Red Band.
Wait a minute. It's not a bad idea.
No.
That's what's fucked up about all of Red Band's suggestions. You go, what? Yeah. Wait a minute.
It's like little scrubbing bubbles.
Does that work? Like if it could turn Clint Eastwood into Chris Pratt. You don't think Clint Eastwood would occasionally jack off into his own face?
You know what he could do, which I believe is sort of how some medicines are made. Perhaps you can have your kids. Actually, you know what? Forget it.
Whoa. But if you knew that jerking off in your own face would make you younger, how often would you do that?
Every day.
Every day. There you
go. That's what's up. That's what's real.
Just try it out.
Sacrifices.
Just rub your jizz in your face and go cut men's hair. Jetski Johnson.
But is Red Band suggesting it because he does it? Because I think that's a good thing we should know, too.
Good question. Red Band, do you rub your own jizz in your face?
No, but, if it's been a couple of days and it starts doing the sprinkler things, a couple of times it's hit me in the cheek and I've rubbed it in just to see,
sprinkler thing. It's not working for Red Band's. I don't know.
I don't know what you just said.
Red Band's pretending like his load is so powerful that it sprinkles everywhere.
Has it done that?
Like it doesn't...
Hold on a second.
It's not a sad, vomiting soul at 4 a.m.
No, that's... Well, yours is going through a bunch of shit.
That's how your cum... Your cum comes out like a volcano. It just runs over the edge.
Yours has a poop worm that comes out first.
What the fuck are
from
you
butt
talking
fucking
about?
Guys.
Right. Oh,
this is
an
amazing workplace argument. That we're all getting to witness
through
the lens of stand-up comedy. Where they talk about their loads.
Red Band just comes Wendy's ketchup.
Justin, you have any special skills or talents? You ever perform on stages and do anything?
Never put on stage before.
Wow. How about anything else? You good at anything? You seem like a bowling or anything like that?
I mean, I can roll one-handed.
You can roll a joint one-handed? Really?
Let's see.
Yeah, let's see it. Can you do it right now?
Got a paper?
Rolling papers?
Yeah.
Probably. Anybody have any rolling papers by now?
I got a $500
bill. This backwood ain't gonna say.
That's okay.
As soon as I learned that like other people will roll joints, I stopped learning.
Yeah.
Yep.
Because everybody's like, you know how to roll a joint?
When was the last?
I mean, I can figure it out. It's not like driving a manual.
Have you done one before, like recently, though, like where you could still make it, but it just looks so sad?
If you give people more money, they just do it for you. You don't have to do that. That's so stupid.
Justin, you talk about...
You roll your own cigars, bro?
You talk about having low serotonin. What in the world makes you the happiest? What are your favorite times?
Probably murder of comedians that make shit talk jokes about them. We got so high before this show. I've been trying to survive this whole time. I'm too high to be talking in public.
What are your
different comedians
moments?
Have been coming up on stage. And Tony looks at me sideways.
Real talk, I'm just, my dad, my kids, man.
You love them.
Yeah.
Adorable. 12, 13, 14, 15, and 16.
Sure.
I love it. All right, man. Well, there you are. You're out there doing it. You still with the baby mama?
Three. But one's up there, yeah.
You got one here?
I got one here, yeah.
Wait, three baby mamas?
I got one here, yes. Yeah. The one I've been with 16 years is here, yes.
Wow, you have three different baby mamas and four kids, 12, 13, 14, 15, and 16.
Wow.
Whatever.
Oh,
God, you're
14,
such a hater.
15, 16,
now it's
man.
Starting to make sense. This guy almost ended up with fucking four 14-year-olds. This guy was one woman away from possibly just hitting the fucking the opposite of the lottery.
He's on fire.
500 goddamn episodes. It's about time I find my role.
Remember when Comedy Central turned this show down?
Yeah, I do. Brilliant.
It's like one of the funniest shows that's ever existed.
Remember Comedy Central?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Red Band nailing
hilarious.
It.
Hilarious. Welcome to Texas, bitches.
Justin Sanford, ladies and gentlemen. Follow him on social media at IrishMade82. He did it. You got up. Kill Tony. Justin Sanford. Here we go. We're going to keep it rolling. This is fun. How exciting.
Speaking of fun.
Whoa, Kaylee. Hey, how many of you traveled from another city to be here tonight? Damn. That is so cool. We appreciate the hell out of you.
Delicious whistle pig.
Yeah. Don't forget, if you're into vodka, drink Fix Vodka. If you're into whiskey, drink Whistle Pig. It's a no-brainer.
And if you're into pussy, go to the Red Rose.
Oh, my God. Okay, this is really, I don't know
what's going on. How about a hand for the fucking band, ladies and gentlemen? That's a real band. That's a legit band.
Nick Dopudja is next. Nick Dopudja is up next on Kill Tony. How exciting. And that's Michael Gonzalez on the drums. John D's on the keys. D Madness on the bass guitar. And Matt Muehling on the electric. Very exciting stuff. Fucking love this band. Freak musicians. Goddamn Austin, Texas. Where the hell is Nick Dopudja? Here he is, everybody. Put your hands together for Nick Dopudja.
Hell yeah. ¿Cómo estás, bitches? Everybody doing well tonight? Oh, fuck yeah. So this is Austin, Texas. I'm from Las Vegas. I heard you guys have a pretty dope yoga scene. Anyone here do yoga?
Pretty dope yoga
scene. It fucking sucks here, dude. I know, I taught yoga for 5 years, and you guys been to Black Swan? Fuck that place, I have to view a whole homeless shelter while I'm in like a Trigonasana, man. What the fuck is that? It's like I'm watching a view and I'm seeing some dude. And breathe. So I taught yoga for 5 years, and a thing we get a lot is that yoga instructors sexually harass their students. Which is fucked up. I don't agree with that. But if you're going to do it, you should do it in a DMX voice. Where my down with dogs at? Hey, yo, where my down with dogs at? That's my time. Thank you.
There it is. Nick Dopudja. Nick, I'm going to be honest with you. I absolutely hate you. I mean, it is unbelievable. It's unbelievable. You have good energy. You have good timing. You have good pacing. You do things well. But it's like you seem like a professional, but I just fucking hate you.
I get it.
Did you think that like talking about one specific yoga place, whatever the Black Swan is, you thought that was going to resonate with a bunch of podcast fans?
No, I just actually went there and legit, while I was doing yoga, it was like people shooting up and you had a whole like tent. I was like, this is fucking interesting.
I know where that spot is. Yeah. It is right next to a homeless camp, right?
Yeah.
What else do you have that's funny? Because that's like people, their life fell apart. They're right next to you trying to be spiritual. And you're like, how inconvenient.
Yeah.
Right. I'm out here trying to connect with the guy in mine. And you fucking losers only have one pair of underwear. That's where you're at, right?
No. It's just like
I know, but it's like it's jokes, right? You're telling jokes. Yeah. But you decided that that's going to be what you talk about. The saddest people on earth. The people that lost everything. I'm fucking with them. If he's not gonna drown, he's gonna swim. We have to decide now.
I mean, so how are people voting in May?
All right, Nick. So let's talk about it. You were on the show a couple weeks ago at Antone's. We talked about you doing yoga. What else didn't we talk about that might be interesting? Good at anything?
What about the yoga? Do you teach it?
Yeah, I taught yoga for like
5 years. That's the problem.
Yeah, yeah, you're way too into it.
All those people are listening to you. All those housewives listen to you. They're stretching deeper.
Yeah.
Holding it longer than they would, but you're telling them to.
How long have you been doing stand-up?
3 years.
3 years, yeah. The yoga thing will be the only time someone asks you to stretch. A stand-up reference.
That's a really inside joke.
Inside baseball, but like stretching means that you do longer than your assigned set in stand-up.
And you gotta do
comedy.
This.
Yeah.
Stretch. They say that from the sidelines.
Like if the next comic's running late or something.
Comedians are fucking irresponsible drug addicts.
Let's talk. Let's keep talking to if Wolverine only did yoga. What else about you, Nick Dopudja? Give us fucking something about your life other than the fact that you fucking jump on a mat every day.
I don't know, man. I do a lot of things. I was rock climbing in Las Vegas. I got heavy into psychology, and I utilized psychedelics to kind of like change my brain a bit. Because I was
you said a lot of things all together that are not really related to each other.
Not related? Yeah, no, they're not related at all. I'm like a space cadet. I like jump around to shit. Mm. Yeah.
Okay.
What's psychology?
Yeah, psychology.
Like, what do you get into?
So what I was doing the yoga, I wanted to like kind of pursue psychology because I feel like there's a renaissance with like psychedelics and it could be really beneficial. So that was kind of like my original plan. I wanted to utilize microdosing with like yoga stuff.
Oh, I fucking hate you so much.
I know.
I'm getting rid of you. You were on a couple weeks ago. This is never going to work out. Ladies and gentlemen, there he goes. Nick DePudja. No. No, I'm moving on. Nick DePudja, thank you. Some of these people were just on. I can't stand it.
Bro, yoga is confusing.
Oh, fuck him. Fuck
it confuses that guy. A lot of people,
Tony. Fuck that
Tony.
Guy. Fuck that guy. God fucking damn it, man. I almost killed myself for him at some point during that. Jesus Christ.
So like after the yoga, I like microdose and I think about psychology and then I think about the yoga and then I fucking, you know what I mean?
Shut the fuck up. All right. It's just like, unbelievable. It's like, go find yourself, bro. Take a chance. I pulled another name.
This show is so important. Right now in this world that we're living in, this show is so goddamn important.
Ladies and gentlemen, your next comedian goes by the name of Jack Schutz, or perhaps Schutz. What do you think that is? A Schutz, I'd say. Seems like a good wrestling name, right? Jack Schutz? That's a name you don't want to wrestle.
Dangerous dude.
Oh, here he is. He's right here. One more time for Jack Schutz, everybody.
How do you say it?
Schutzy. Schutzy.
Come on, make some noise for Jack Schutzy, everybody.
Hi, guys. My name's Jack Schutze. I'm hyper self-critical, so I'll either be killing it up here or myself later. Judging by the looks of this room, I shouldn't be alone. I like making fun of suicide because those that are the best at it have the least to say. Texans like to pretend they care about history. Texans don't care about history. I can prove it to you. Texans don't care about history because they let the coaches teach it. In the portables. Y'all been there. Y'all been there. Say, Coach Saucier. All right, team. All right, team. Today we're studying the rise of Rome to illustrate the year 2000 dramatic historical film Gladiator. Next week, we'll be studying the dynasty in China to illustrate the year 2000 film Gladiator. We just passed an amazing an anniversary of a really tragic accident. Kobe Bryant had his death. And we all know he went down on that helicopter. We just hope he asked for consent first. All right, thank you.
Oh, dude, you were doing so good.
Yeah.
If you just bailed at
hey,
the
just
view.
From here from L.A., don't get mad.
It's out of my hands.
It was.
I gotta stop.
It was so good. The only one that laughed at that Kobe joke was Kobe. He's like, ah, fucked up right there at the end. But that was a great set. I love you, Jack. How about a big hand for Jack Schutze, everybody. It was a great set.
I'm super excited. My family has a historical. We built a building across Congress from Austin, and we lost it all in the 60s, and now I'm trying to build it back up again. So
you lost it all in the 60s?
Like,
what do
they
you mean?
Were a competitive company with Walmart. Walmart came in and just dropped dick on the whole
Schutzies?
Fucking business.
Was it called Schutzies?
It's called Tips, but just not even Tips? A joke there. It was literally Tips Hardware, Austin, Texas. If you're 60 plus, you know it, but sorry.
Yeah, nobody.
I think I just found the new name of my comedy club.
Just the Tips?
Just the Tips.
Just half a million? We good.
Oh, shit. There it is. All right.
Good luck. Good luck with all that.
Jack, what do you do for work?
I was a chef, and now I'm an accountant.
You're an accountant?
What happened with the whole cooking thing?
I wanted to be able to do stuff like this, and I'd be in a kitchen right now. So.
Right.
That makes sense, because it wouldn't taste good. It would just be jokes.
What do you mean? What the fuck does that mean?
Well, no, chefs,
I want to do something just like this.
Professional chefs have to work at night.
Every
that
night,
makes sense.
Yeah.
They have to work. So normally you miss like all your family birthdays. This isn't funny. Let's talk about funny stuff.
Yeah, we'll get there. We'll get there. You just tell us the truth, and then we'll make it.
We're
funny.
Just trying to figure out who you are.
No,
you said you used to be a chef.
Yeah,
but you loved it.
So. Trying to open my own business. I had an accounting degree, met my wife, she's a CPA, so I was like, fuck it, I'll be an accountant for a while, and then I'll try stand up. Who knows?
Okay.
Who knows?
What else in life? What else do you, what do you and the lady do for fun?
Normally go out stuff like this, but since COVID, I mean, this is, we're here a lot at the Paramount, see shows, comedy.
Yeah? You come to the Paramount a lot?
Yeah.
Okay. What else? What are any hobbies?
Have you guys tried ketamine?
No, we are going too soon. We are going too soon. Big mushroom fans.
You should
fans.
Try
Big
ketamine.
You know,
immediately. No children yet?
I've met God, if that's
ketamine.
What you're trying to get to.
How about yoga? You ever do yoga?
Only
yoga, yoga on ketamine with that other dude.
No.
Brain produces this chemical.
I'm sorry.
You guys should scissor each other.
I might look a little stiff. This is my third time performing comedy. So
congratulations.
It's
wow,
it's
really good. Really great for third. I mean,
get
third
together
time.
With the last guy who's a really good musician and figure out what you two can do together.
I tell more personal stuff, but it's just not long enough here. You know, it's kind of. I got a bunch of one-liners that are really brutal, but, you know.
You do. Wait.
If you only have one arm, string cheese. It's just cheese, bro.
Oh, that's a good one. Okay.
I got some other ones.
Any joke where you have to go like this afterwards isn't that good.
Unless it is.
Is it because you didn't get it or because the joke wasn't good?
Well,
I'm trying to roast you like that other guy.
Don't make that noise.
Oh, shit.
No. Okay, so Jack, tell us more about you. Give us something good about your life, your family, something really interesting.
So going,
what makes you different?
Going from working in restaurants to working in an office is super interesting. This isn't a joke. This is serious. Our last conversation I had in restaurants was like, by show of hands, who stuck their finger in their ass? And then like I go to work in an office, and they're like, oh, my daughter's working for a pharmacy. It's like, my friends rob pharmacies, and it's like, that's honestly shit that happens when you transition from those things.
Don't you miss those people in the kitchen?
I do so much. That's why I'm here.
Get back
that's why
to
I'm here. That's
bitch.
Why I'm here. That's why I'm
Jack,
here.
Jack, you seem like such a genuinely good man. What's the worst thing you've ever done in your life?
You, serious?
Yeah.
Okay. Absolutely serious.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
So, I had this girlfriend on and off real young. First, we were girlfriend like seventh grade. Around sophomore year, I had a friend, and we were in PE Warriors. So people know what that means. PE Warriors.
Hold on, and stop. Does anyone know what that means?
Only people over 60.
If you're in PE, it just means like you don't have a mascot, so you're not on the team, so you're a fucking PE Warrior.
It doesn't
so
matter
anyway,
for this fucking
okay, so
story,
this sort of thing.
Jack.
So, good friend there. Good friend there. I've never told anybody this. We made
but
friends.
Let's do he it
said
online.
He really loved this girl. She was my ex. Yeah. And I said, fuck her. She's a cunt bag. Don't. She's like, she's terrible. She'll fuck you up. He started dating her.
Uh-huh.
Years later, I looked up. And I was like, man, I just want to date her again. And so I stole my friend's girlfriend.
How'd you do it?
I just went up and was like, hey, this guy's a loser. You should date me. But he fucking is dead now.
Whoa.
We should definitely edit this podcast.
He's dead.
Everyone
that's the truth.
Here, listen
that's the truth.
To me.
He wanted to know
to
the most fucked up
thing.
He asked.
You were here. You're lucky. You're lucky you're a part of this thing and no one's ever going to see.
Just be happy your girlfriend's
don't
cool?
Like me. Can we be cool? Shut the fuck up. Can we be cool?
Hey, give me this 1 million and I'll shut the fuck
shit,
up.
But he doesn't feel good about it. Can we let it go?
Give it to me, Tony.
Wouldn't it be the first time there was a murderer on this show?
That is true. Oh. There's been a murderer on this show before.
Where's
the guy that pushed the girl up.
Where's our Purse House fans at?
Wait, what?
There you go. Yeah, all at once. The guy that killed Drew Carey's ex-girlfriend?
Yeah.
He got pulled out of the bucket.
And my jokes
show.
Need references.
I was interviewed by Jesus. All the like NBC, Fox.
Yeah, right,
oh, my God, that's right.
Yeah, everybody, every news outlet, including like Dateline, used clips of Kill Tony. It's very exciting. It was the best press we ever got.
Did they give you the at Kill Tony?
No, they didn't even do that.
If you were on NBC, they would, right? It's rude.
I guess so. I don't know.
No, it's rude. Yeah. What you did
Tony
tonight,
gave me a look like I'm not supposed to tell jokes here.
Jesus.
You
Jeff.
Look like you're not supposed to tell jokes?
Shh.
Yeah. What you did tonight.
Huh?
It's cool. Hey, guys, good night. This is such a
Where
great set.
Going?
Thank you so much.
Wait,
Jack,
no,
shoot
wait a second.
Don't
wait a
leave.
Second. Jack, what the fuck
don't
is
pull
wrong
shoot.
With you?
I don't know, man.
Hang I'm in there.
I liked you. I don't know if you saw. I kicked a fucking pussy-ass yoga guy out of here a minute ago. And then here we are. We're just having a talk. Or why are you panicking over
I'm
there?
Cool. Third time, man. This is
listen, man.
Stage,
you
it's
can't
not a lot
control
stage,
the narrative.
Stage.
Jesus.
That's
Christ.
True. That's true.
You think you get
that's
to decide when you fucking leave?
You can't control the narrative, man.
That's right. You don't decide when you get
Why
to
do you
fucking
think
leave.
I'm back from
Fuck
LA.
You. I won't do what you tell me.
How many of you think we should make Jack stand against this curtain for the rest of the episode just for trying to leave? Here he is. He's part of the set, everybody. It's a Jack statue.
Thank you.
Come on. Stand back here, Jack.
Jack, you don't have to listen to
no,
him, man.
Keep the microphone in the
As
mic
As your attorney, no, I, was gonna I walk advise away. You
I will stand,
to act if, on your conscience.
If you give me 5 minutes somewhere, I'll stand that way against this.
What?
Crowd.
What?
If I give you what? There he goes. He's done. Go back
Thank
to your
you.
Seat.
Thank you.
Jack shoots. I'll stand Take against over. The wall if you let me perform for 5 more minutes.
Joe, so you think we should have edited it right after like that first half
for
of
sure,
his joke?
For sure, 100%.
And then he just leaves after that.
Well,
that's a good idea.
We have to save ourselves.
Yeah.
It would be funny.
Aww. This show is just
It would be funny
than
if
ever.
We had a moment in this podcast where it just cut to black and then went back in a really obvious edit.
Yeah, that would
and
be
only
fun.
Only we know.
We did that a couple
it's
times.
It's not that it's bad.
Yeah.
Listen, it's not that it's bad, but it would be funny.
Phillip.
What if we can make an agreement where no one in this room would tell, and we'll just chop that part out? All that crazy shit.
Trust me,
it might get us kicked off YouTube. Let's just shut the fuck up. Can we just shut the fuck up? Can you shut the fuck up? I can shut the fuck up. Are you my friends? Are you my brothers and sisters?
Philip Garcia.
Can we help that guy and shut the fuck up? I see phones. I see you lying. I see a lot of your phones out.
Put your fucking phones away. Ladies and gentlemen,
Terrible
your next comedian
people.
Goes by the name of Philip Garcia.
Fuck yeah.
Philip Garcia.
I love Philip.
You know Philip. We know Philip. He's been here before. Hey! Bah, bah, bah. Oh, yeah, this is a monster, everybody. Make some noise for Philip Garcia.
Let's get a little clap going, everybody, just like. Hey, everybody, and I'm here to say that my name's Philip, and I'm not gay. But my dad is. Yeah, my dad's gay. He's fucking my friend from high school. My weed dealer from high school. Right? My wife's a Pornhub title at this point. And I still can't get a good deal on weed either. What the fuck is that about? I don't know how to tell my dad that he needs to suck better dick. That's a... Used to call him Papa Bear, not so much anymore. You know, it's a... I should have known when we were kids, we'd go on bicycle rides, he'd take his seat off, and that's going to be the... Thank you, I'm Philip Garcia.
Philip Garcia. Wow.
Fuck yeah.
Absolutely. Philip melee'd a single Kill Tony appearance into multiple spots just a couple weeks ago at Antone's. Showed up to the Death Squad show, absolutely destroyed.
Yeah, a couple of times.
Yeah,
great.
Opening for me April 17th
yeah,
on my
show. Yeah, I barely
show.
Got here. I had a flat tire as soon as I exited 35, and then I just moved here today, actually, so I had all my shit packed.
Uh-oh.
Yeah, what's up, Austin?
Another one.
Dude,
Yeah. That was funny. You're really funny.
Thanks, Joe.
You're really brave, too. Like,
thank you.
Your subjects are brave.
Thank you. It's all true. So.
So, of course, you got a flat tire, right? You know that, right? Yeah. That's how the universe is going to do you.
Yeah.
What do you do for work?
Where do I work? So, I'm still doing pest control like 2-3 days a week up in
DFW. Of course you are.
Yeah.
Pest control.
Got to.
2-3 days a week.
Yeah. And then I just got my place down here so I can stay like Wednesday through Monday and keep seeing y'all
guys.
That's
perfect. Awesome. What kind of wallet do you have?
Wallet?
Yeah. Let me see your wallet.
Empty.
Look at the size of that
huge wallet.
Oh my God, he's got a checkbook. Yeah. Holy shit. You know what, Philip? You're not going to believe this, but I want to give you a new wallet. Compliments of our friends over at the Ridge Wallet. This is a brand new titanium
Ridge wallet.
Yeah, just for you. And if you open it up, you're going to find out that the great people over at Ridge Wallet decided to put $500 inside of it. Yep.
You just paid for my toe, dude.
Yep.
No fucking way.
Yep.
Oh, money!
You're welcome.
Oh, man.
$500 thanks to the great people over at Ridge Wallet. Mine is carbon fiber. That one is titanium.
Yeah, it's awesome.
The whole crew has them.
It's the best wallet in the entire world. You should buy one right now.
Yeah. They're the shit.
Yeah. I don't have one.
They are the shit. And you don't have to use your... Look at the size of that clunky fucking thing.
It's like half a cow's ass. That's
what
this
the
is.
What fuck is that?
By the way, this is the second time that the great people at Ridge have given us a wallet. And we had no idea we were going to give it to Philip. We had no idea he was getting called. And the two times that we've done it, both people have had the most ridiculous wallets. One guy had a piece of like manila paper.
How did you know?
You wouldn't believe this. The only other time we've done this, and I think I'm sure there's some fans here that probably know this. The only other time we ever did it, you know, we never know who we're going to give it to or whatever. So it's like I'm feeling it out, and I'm like, oh, he got towed. Oh, he works pest control 2 or 3 days a week. This guy's going to get it. But both times, and the other guy was poor too, but both times I've asked, and this is true. You could look back on this episode, wherever it is, and find it. But I asked him, what does your wallet look like? And I swear to God, he pulled out a tiny manila envelope that had a rip down the middle. It was just that. He's like, oh, my wallet's shit, man.
It's
like,
just a little
ka-ching! Like, you got to be kidding me. I'm always hoping they don't pull out a fucking Ridge wallet.
Yeah.
Well, the only good thing I own is this Ridge wallet.
But don't you think there's something weird about the synchronicity of this evening?
Yeah.
And there's so many things between you and David Lucas and all these other people. There's a weird synchronicity to it that almost seems artificial.
You want
to
see more synchronicity? You want to see some more? You rapped.
Yes.
You rapped to start your set tonight.
What?
Why don't we have someone else come up here and do a real quick rap? You guys might recognize him.
Are you talking about Danny Brown?
One of the most legendary guests in the history of Kill Tony and brand new resident of Austin, Texas. Make some noise for Danny motherfucking Brown, everybody.
What?
Yes.
I didn't even know this.
I know. Oh, what the fuck is happening? Holy shit. Holy shit. Holy shit. Holy shit.
Holy shit.
So you just gonna make me rap, man? God damn it. What's up? What's up? What the fuck's up, Austin?
Danny Brown, ladies and gentlemen. Danny Brown.
So you just gonna get up here and make me do this shit. All right, all right, all right. Fuck, 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 fuck. I guess it's pretty much just like, okay. Because I would do this even without a record deal. And half the shit I say won't be understood by executives. I'm from that crack rock pawn your grandma wedding ring. So what the fuck you gonna tell me about anything? Strap up, nigga, get your boots on tight. I'm from back when Snoop called Luca Frisco Dyke. Made moves, went left, you went right. Niggas wanna be hot till they souls on nice. Long as I got the rent, can't tell me shit. You ain't got it, put you out like Hannibal Buress.
Detroit Danny Brown
is
in the motherfucking house.
What the fuck's up, Tony?
Is there anything you'd like to say to the fans of Kill Tony? We haven't heard of you or seen you since that Detroit episode.
Yeah, I was going through a lot that time.
Danny, we talked about
I would just like
that.
To say,
Vulcan.
It was a lot of Adderall. And Adderall and liquor basically turns to cocaine at that point, so... I was going through a breakup at the time. I didn't give a fuck about life.
I love that episode. That's one of my favorite episodes.
It was pretty fun.
It was great. People loved it. People loved it.
Yeah. Yeah.
Danny, you just moved here to Austin, Texas.
That's right.
We're all here together now. We're all hanging.
Danny Brown.
That's right.
We're going to dinner this week.
Life yeah, man. Good. You sold me out last week.
Well, something came up.
I know. I'm like, this nigga still in L.A. God damn, I thought you moved to Texas and shit changed.
Trust me, it's very surreal to have to change plans with Danny Brown. It hurt me, too. I'm like, what am I doing?
I know. Yeah. I mean, save yourself a precinct visit, maybe.
This is a weird town.
It's great. I love it here. I mean, what do you know.
What do you love about it so far? You been to an H-E-B yet?
I mean, I started coming to Austin from South by Southwest. Uh-huh. You know what I'm saying? So I've been coming here like every year since I've been a fucking rapper. You know what I'm saying? So I developed a great relationship with this city, you know?
I fucking love it. You have such a great energy. You're one of my favorite artists.
Thank you, guys.
Ladies and gentlemen, make some noise. Just a quick cameo from one of the greatest fucking rappers in the world. Detroit Danny Brown is now Austin Danny Brown, ladies and gentlemen.
What have you done, Tony Hinchcliffe?
Chaos.
What have you done?
This is Kill Tony 500. You guys want to go to the bucket again, huh? Let's see what happens here.
Do you have Go to the Bucket t-shirts available online?
Ooh, no, that's a good idea, though.
Must.
We are working on Kill Tony. We're working on Kill Tony bingo cards right now that we think are going to be our greatest piece of merch ever. Where things happen on Kill Tony and you mark your bingo cards and you just play along, maybe by yourself, maybe
with
friends.
Yeah, because I'm sure you have a lot of bingo fans. you fucking savage, barbarian, psychedelic-taking audience.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, pulled another name out of the bucket. Let's see what happens here. This is a cool name, Ridge Hirschberger. The stylings of Ridge Hirschberger. Talk about synchronicity. We just gave away a Ridge wallet. The next comedian is Ridge Hirschberger.
Damn.
His first name is Ridge. The company that makes Ridge Wallet is called Ridge. This is Ridge. Ridge Hirschberger. One more time for Ridge, everybody.
Holy cow. I have never seen this many people in my whole life. I have an interesting family. My uncle, he's 100% Amish. And it's weird whenever we have family reunions and stuff. They all have beards, even the men. I was told this would be an Amish friendly crowd. Oh, how I was misinformed. I grew up on a dairy farm in central Pennsylvania. I have touched so many titties. I may have even sucked on one or two. You know how people talk about this farm to table? I don't believe in that. No. I believe in something better than that. Utter to mouth. Thank you, guys.
Hell yeah, Ridge Hirschberger. My God, are you fucking real?
Yeah.
My goodness. Do you know how to yodel or anything like that? Are you a yodeler?
No.
You know how to play the spoons? You're the ham bone or anything
like that?
The
spoons? Like the game you play spoons? Like a card game?
You know how to play that?
No.
All right. Ridge, where do you live now?
Here in Austin.
When did you move here from central Pennsylvania?
A week and a half ago.
Wow, look at that. Everyone's moving here. Even people that milk cows.
What's the redhead dude's name?
William Montgomery, yeah.
Why don't you give William Montgomery your suspenders?
Okay. Get out here, William.
Help him.
I'm serious.
You don't need him.
What happened? Are those really holding up your pants?
Not really.
No.
No.
But they kind of give me a moose knuckle, don't they?
Ridge, what made you move here a week and a half ago?
What?
What made you move here?
Comedy.
Yep.
Okay.
And I got to get away from my mom.
Right. She's
your
in
mom.
Central.
Yeah, she just wants me to churn butter all the time.
Central PA, huh? What are we talking about? Doylestown?
Altoona.
Hmm. Fiddle of nowhere.
Yeah, bumfuck.
What happened to your mom?
I said the F word.
Your mom?
My mom's not going to be able to see this.
She doesn't have the internet. Come on,
yeah,
Ridge.
Yeah, who am I kidding?
She has smoke signals.
What's up with your mom?
She's a lovely lady.
Oh, wow. Jesus Christ. Wow, she's still paying your bills, bro?
Sexual tension?
You're milking her, too, huh? Not just milking cows out there in Central PA, or maybe she
what
is.
What happened?
Maybe she is a cow.
What happened?
What happened?
With what?
With everything.
Oh, I don't know, dude.
Let's be real.
What happened? I was homeschooled.
How old are you?
23.
Suspenders.
Suspenders, yes.
Why?
Why?
Yeah, what? What's happening? Where's your mom?
I miss her.
Oh, my God. Ridge, are you okay?
I don't know.
Clearly, he's not.
Normally, the country boys have, like, real mental balance.
I have children. We need to hug him.
Yeah.
It's like Scary the Cable Guy.
I thought Larry the Cable Guy, like, really worked on electricity and stuff.
Uh-uh.
Of course he did.
Yeah.
No one was around to teach you otherwise.
Yeah.
So tell us about your life, Ridge, other than being homeschooled and making it out here. Like,
are we going to have two edits in this podcast?
How are you blending into civilization?
Terrible.
Yeah. What do you do for fun?
What do I do for fun? We catch pigeons.
Really?
Yeah. You like?
Told you.
What did you say? What do you say? What are you talking about?
I love that answer.
What are you whispering?
Trust me, it's been almost 8 years. This is 500 fucking episodes. You count like 10 comedians times 500, whatever the fuck that is, 5,000 fucking people. You think I've ever gotten the answer? I catch pigeons. I love it. Give me new shit, please. Just don't answer. All I do is yoga and microdose. Suspenders is a rare treat as well.
He might be number one, right?
Yeah, it could be.
He's the first non-fat guy with suspenders.
We have a resident suspenders guy, the great Yoni.
It's
is
a
here,
weird
right?
choice.
Oh, there's some big Yoni fans in the audience. Yoni, is he here?
What happened?
Wow, the opportunity of a lifetime missed. There it goes. And Ridge Hirschberger, what's something crazy that you've done? You ever get in trouble with your mom? Like, God damn it, Ridge, you really
fucked
up.
Stop fucking me, mom.
Crazy.
Hey, there he is. There's Yoni, everybody. Yoni! Look, his suspenders are blending in. This guy sleeps with fucking suspenders on all day, every day.
It's coming back like the fanny pack.
There he is, the suspender king. What do you think of this guy's suspenders, Yoni?
They're great. I got the same pair.
He's got the same pair. There it is. I just wanted to check in with you. We got to have Yoni every time a guy with suspenders.
I was so pissed when I came here and I saw he had suspenders. He's like my arch nemesis.
Yeah.
I hate him.
Yeah, and he's also, much like you, he's also fucked your mother.
Oh, goodness. It is my dad.
I just, very rarely do I do that. I just had to do it. It's only funny because he did it. You fucked your mother, Ridge. We know it.
Don't let him bully you as your attorney.
Ridge, you ever get in trouble for anything?
Yeah.
Like what?
I got a DUI.
Really?
Yeah.
And then what I had fucking way.
And then I had to go to Amish rehab. I had to go with my uncle and live there with him for a month.
Oh, my God.
They didn't have any electricity or anything.
It smelled like shit.
Yeah. Yeah, it did.
You've also stayed at his uncle's place before?
His name is Serenus.
Ridge, you have a girlfriend?
No.
Have you ever had sex with a woman?
Besides your mom?
Honest question, Ridge. I'm not trying to be funny here. Are you a virgin?
Here goes my clean comedian. Yeah.
You're a virgin?
No.
Okay.
Yeah.
So you've had sex with a woman.
Oh, wait. Was this a setup? Were you going to be like, anyways?
Jesus Christ. You might be right, Joe. Joe was the first one to say this guy could
okay.
be a serial killer.
He's just, he's, you know.
Socially.
You're going to be okay. How many times did you stand up?
Probably like 50 or so.
50? What year did you start?
It's 2021. 2019, like 2 years, but like the pandemic, you can't do anything.
So, did you always want to be a stand-up, or is it like a whim? What are you doing?
I didn't know being a stand-up was a thing you could do till like age 18,
And then I found out that was something you could do, and I was like, holy shit, I love this.
Yeah, I didn't actually find out until, like, I was 21. Like, I always thought it was, for some reason, I always thought it was a weird, like, nepotism thing. I'm like, oh, these people must have, like, famous parents or whatever. I swear to God, like, I just couldn't imagine. When I found out that you could just go to open mics and just start, and, like, you get to do it as often as you want, it blew my fucking mind. I'm like, you don't have to pay to do the thing to get better. Everything else you have to pay to get better at it, to do it. You take classes and all this bullshit. This was just open mics. My mind was blown. Anyway, so I'm sort of like you in that way. Ridge, let's talk. I need to, for some reason, my instinct
what's
is telling me to ask
him. What's the reason why he does it?
Why do you do stand-up?
I don't know. Because I enjoy it and it's fun. And
what's your favorite part
about stand-up? Making people laugh and having fun.
When was the last time that happened?
Oh man!
Like on purpose?
On purpose? I don't know. Last night.
There you go. You're doing it. How long have you been doing it? 3 years? Enough to move to Austin.
Yeah.
You're starting to make more sense as the interview goes on.
Yeah. Something, you're relaxing.
Something.
It's like we've been talking about all night. There's a stage you have to get where you can be yourself.
Yeah. It's really hard.
My gut keeps telling me that I have to ask you about your love life. I have to follow up on this. I got a wibbly wobbly answer about you being whether you've had sex or not. Are you very sexually active or not so much?
No, not so much.
One girlfriend?
I've never had a girlfriend. I mean, in high school, but does that really count?
How tight are you with that funny non-binary guy?
I'm sitting right next to him up there.
Really? Question. Next to each other? Side by side.
I put his name. Right? I signed up for him. He got first. Now
incredible. That's against the rules of Kill Tony, by the way.
Ridge.
So you've only had a girlfriend in high school. When's the last time you kissed a girl?
Like 2 weeks ago.
Who was that?
It was a cute farm girl.
Really?
Yeah.
Are you just saying?
Was she
that?
Awake?
Yes.
Was she related to you?
When was the last time you had sex?
Over a year ago.
Over a year ago?
How about on purpose?
Oh, my God. She's killing me.
All right, Ridge. Well, we tried our absolute best. You last long in the bedroom? You have any special moves? You do the fucking you milk the cow or whatever?
Fucking milk the cow or whatever.
I squeezed, please.
I don't know.
You ever gotten a lap dance before?
Yeah.
Oh, well.
Oh, no. Not fair.
Never.
Not from a human.
What about the Wild Thing?
What?
Tone Loke. Wild Thing.
Wild Thing?
Yeah.
What are you saying?
Don't. Wild Thing. Don't. Have you ever gotten a lap dance to Wild Thing?
No.
What kind of American are you, boy? No lap dance, a Wild Thing, Tony.
Should we do
how
it?
How do we
should
correct we do this it? Issue?
Come on, let's go. Ladies and gentlemen, thanks to our friends over at the Yellow Rose. No, it's okay. No, Jetski, take that back. Take that back. We have an actual chair. There you go. Yeah, absolutely. Jetski doesn't know stool. You don't get lap dances on stools. That's a death wish. Holy shit, what is happening? Wow. Kill Tony 500 presents our first lap dance. Oh my God. Rich, your mother's gonna see this. Woo! Yellow Rose, Red Rose. Let me come in.
Really? Sat there like an Al Qaeda guy getting questioned by SEALs.
Give it up for Kaylee, guys.
Kaylee.funk73 on Instagram. Kaylie. God damn it. One last question for you, Ridge.
Ridge.
What do you think your mother's going to say when she sees that part of the podcast?
I don't know.
God, this guy's hard as a rock. He doesn't need a suspender for his dick right now, that's for sure. That is a self-suspension machine. Look at that. He's got a little milk in his pants right now. There he goes, everybody. Ridge Hirschberger.
Ridge.
Good job, Ridge. Congratulations. All right. You guys think we should get another regular up here? Finish this thing out, huh?
Let's keep going until everybody falls asleep.
How about one? Come on, guys. How loud can this place get for Kaylee, everybody? Come on. She joined the Kill Tony family just a couple weeks ago, and boy, what a wild hit this has been. Oh, yeah, your hat. There it is. There it is. The great Kaylee, everybody. That's her hat. It says titties. Ladies and gentlemen, your next comedian, regular on this show, has been through a lot, was the first person other than Red Band and I, out of this whole crew, and of course Joe was here first, but the first guy to move out here was the one who seemed to be the least likely to do so, but no one loves stand-up more than this guy. He started only a few years ago. We found him a little over a year ago in Hollywood at the Comedy Store and immediately kept inviting him back. He's an absolute monster, a super, super black belt out of Second City in Chicago, written about in history books there, just started stand-up after being diagnosed with ALS, fresh off of coming out with a clean bill of health after the coronavirus. Ladies and gentlemen, it is the one and the only Michael Lehrer, everybody. The real fucking deal.
Woo!
Fuck microdose. It's time for your microdose. Yeah! The people are awesome, are animals. You broke me in 8 weeks. You broke me like a horse. And all my stupid poured out. And committing daily felonies. Bragging about it to capacity crowds. Thank God you defunded your police. I can't go to jail. In the shower, I get butt-fucked and electrocuted. Your Texans are not human beings. How the fuck did the South lose the war? Did you run out of cocaine? That's why you defunded the police. You're all criminals. None of you get the vaccine for free. None of you. Oh, you deserve it. Show me your checking account. If any of you pre-ordered a smash burger on the internet and then waited one day to go win the line for a fucking internet hamburger during the pandemic, no free vaccine.
Can I just say one thing?
Yeah, Joe Rogan. 1 minute.
How the fuck did the South lose the war? Did you run out of cocaine?
Hilarious.
Was one of my favorite moments of this night.
Without a doubt.
Thank you.
Michael's the only person who we don't even give a kitten to, and he's just coming off of a real battle with the coronavirus.
Yeah, I went to the hospital twice. Feel sorry for me.
But just to show you how powerful this fucking guy is, got a clean bill of health on Saturday.
When did you get it?
I had it basically like for 9 days, real bad, about a week and a half ago.
Yeah, real bad he had it.
Yeah.
And in his two appearances, one on Monday back and one here, he both times did 2 minutes. Just straight up, just brand new material. Nothing anybody's ever heard before.
You know, I
setting a new bar. This is something that regulars just simply have never really done or taken advantage of.
Well, I'm sentimental and a cunt, but my sentimentals are like, I love comedy ever since I was a fucking little fucking four-year-old boy, and I got pulled out of this bucket December 2nd, 2019, and I'm a bigger comic than I've ever been. I'm better, and I'm here now, and I can focus on just getting good, and there's nothing in life more fucking cool than that.
Wow. 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 You are the opposite of that fucking yoga microdose guy. It is incredible. I love you so much.
No truer words have ever been spoken. That was beautiful, man. That was so real.
Yeah.
That's Thank who you, you are. That was Thank who you, you are. That's beautiful. And that fucking joke about how the South lost, that's funny. That's Thank funny you. As fuck, dude. That's real. Did you run out of cocaine? What happened?
And that's another part of this wild story is everything he's saying is true. He went down like a real, he was on a real bender for a few weeks. He got, he was hanging around some wild people and Austin is fucking, I guess everybody, no one warned me that everybody's on uppers here, but.
We need to kill a mediocre homeless person and transfer their energy into your body.
Yes.
Let it rise. Rise Thank from the ashes like a phoenix.
But you came back from that. You're back from the coronavirus. What else has happened, Michael?
Well, I have a very special announcement. May I take over, Tony?
Sure. Go right ahead. I love you so much.
Now, thank you. Now, ladies and gentlemen, 22 years ago, around now, I had a baby. No, hold on. And that baby, my son, is here tonight. Shut up. Now, I wrote for my son, who I did not raise, but I forced to perform to make me look like a super dad. I wrote for my son, a blind middle of Kentucky jokes. Yeah! Who wants to hear my son do a minute of blind, never before read jokes I'm forcing him to do, cause I know it's funny and he doesn't, and he's so fucking impatient with me. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the stage, my boy, Colin Heenan.
All right.
Hello. I'm Colin. I'm from Wyoming. But I've been preparing for tonight for over 2 years by waiting tables at Texas Roadhouse. And if that popular steakhouse chain has taught me anything about Texans, y'all love America. Fried pickles and free refills. Beside being a top young rising comedian, I'm also an actor. Hashtag thespians. Do it on stage. And thanks to gender blind casting, I'll be playing Shirley Temple in an upcoming biopic. I've been a hunter since I was 12. My dad wants me to take him sometime. How would that work? I would be like Chewbacca, with him in my backpack like C-3PO. He'd shoot off half my curls. Kanye now lives in Wyoming. We go camping. It's convenient, because we can both sleep in Kim's butt. Thank you.
Wow.
Let's hear from my son.
That's a real deal. Colin Lehrer and Michael Lehrer. How fucking cool is that? A father-son moment.
Hell yeah. We've been doing this every year on vacations for 10 years, and we always find a fun bit, and it's the best fucking thing ever.
What now, a cool thing.
Yeah. Get off stations, my moment. Good leave.
There he goes, Colin Lehrer.
Now, Tony.
Uh-oh.
May I say something?
Yeah, absolutely. Permission granted.
Now, thank you. Now, I talk a lot about what garbage people live in this city, but I know that it's a great place. I'm happy to call home. And in fact, I love any city where at any hour of the day you can find an ex-junkie singing Counting Crows' Mr. Jones. So, fire up, man. Let's fucking do this right now. Sha-la-la-la-la-la-la. Yeah. Oh,
tra la 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 la.
Oh, bring it down.
Oh yeah.
Down on the new heroin. Stand at this yellow heroin. Miss Heroin tries to have a conversation with some heroin. Heroin does it. She dances. She's on heroin. Oh. Oh, why so much heroin? Man, I wish I was heroin. You would have to say I'm the money. Hi, heroin. Yeah. Vice me some heroin, Mr. Heroin. Believe in heroin. Help me believe in heroin. Cause I want to be someone who believes in heroin. Mr. Heroin, fuck you.
Jesus.
Fuck you.
Michael Lehrer, everybody! Kill Tony 500. Wow. Unbelievable. MichaelLehrerComedy.com for everything Michael Lehrer. What do you guys say? Should we go to the bucket just one more time, huh? All right, this is it. And then we're out of here for sure. Ladies and gentlemen, your final comedian of the night goes by the name of Ski Mask Pete. Oh boy, this sounds interesting. Come on, guys, put your hands together for Ski Mask Pete. Here we go. Oh, shit, here he is. Come on, one more time for Ski Mask Pete. It's your final comedian of the night, everyone.
I think I have a chameleon infestation, but there's no real way of telling. It took them 25 tries to make SpaghettiOs. Spaghetti A. Nope. I went to a palm reader last week, and then she said, if your hand is bigger than your face, then you have cancer. I don't mind pedophiles, but that's just because I hate little kids.
Wow.
Bro!
Ski mask, Pete, bro! What the fuck?
Bro!
What the fuck,
that
man?
That was awesome.
Wow, dude, welcome to the show. How long you been doing stand-up?
3 years.
3 years, huh?
Yeah.
When did you get out?
3 years ago.
Wow, ski mask.
That was some funny shit.
So cool, man.
That was really, really funny shit,
man. Thank you.
I laughed hard.
You're undercover. Wow, look at you.
What are you going to do when the coronavirus shit passes?
Probably get AIDS or something.
No, are you going to keep the mask?
Oh, yeah, I was doing this before corona.
Oh, that's not good, bro. That's not good.
You got to do what you got to do.
You're fucking funny, man. Get rid of that stupid mask.
Let me see what you look like. Ski mask Pete. This is incredible.
Dude, you're too funny, man. That's too good.
What ethnicity are
you? That's too good. Anybody can pretend to be you.
Yeah, what ethnicity are you? I can't tell.
I'm Mexican.
Oh, you're Mexican. Wow, look at that.
Allegedly.
You have any special skills or talents or anything like that?
Yeah, I play the drums.
Oh, really? You do?
Yeah, and honestly, what I gotta say is, what the fuck is up, Austin? What the fuck is up? That's right. And I got a fucking bone to pick with this guy right here.
Oh, shit.
I think we got some unfinished fucking business right now. And like I said, I'm ready to die for this shit, and today's a good day to die. What the fuck is up?
Oh my God. Ladies and gentlemen, it is Joelberg Joel Jimenez. The all-time undefeated drummer of Kill Tony. Joel, when we moved to Austin and you stayed back in LA organically, somehow coincidentally, John Dees, the leader of the new band, just happened to hire an actual Mexican drummer to be the Kill Tony band drummer. And you are here.
I don't know who this guy is. I haven't seen him. I don't know if he even exists.
Well, I'll tell you this. You're both drummers, and you're both Mexican, and this is the end of the show. So I don't know what you guys think, but I'm pretty sure we should have a fucking Mexican drum off to end this
thing. Hell yeah, let's do it.
Shit! Michael Gonzalez was prepared!
I feel like I'm in a Robert Rodriguez movie!
This is wild! It is! Hey. Since Joelberg has never lost a Mexican drum off, I feel like it's right that he gets to go second. Austin's own Michael Gonzalez will be going first. Oh shit! That's already more Mexican than any Mexican drum off's ever been. Ladies and gentlemen, you're going to decide. We have an unbelievable situation. A guy who's never competed in a Mexican drum off, that's the legit resident Mexican drummer of the Kill Tony band, is vying off against a man who is literally 36-0 and has defended his throne across the world, never losing a Mexican drum off. This is unbelievable. Going first, anything can happen. This is a drum solo by the current resident Mexican drummer. Ladies and gentlemen, make some noise for Michael Gonzalez. Holy shit. This is the first time we can truly say Juulberg has his work cut out for him. This is unbelievable. Ladies and gentlemen, I mean, again, we've seen it in Australia, in England, in Ireland, all across America. This guy has always said he's willing to die up here before he ever loses a Mexican drummer. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you a guy that was the drummer for this show for literally hundreds of episodes. It is the return of Juulberg Joel Jimenez. Ladies and gentlemen, the purple dildo we have not seen in perhaps a year, ladies and gentlemen. It is famous amongst Kiltony fans. He's making adjustments.
They're chanting.
He is touching. He is making more adjustments to the symbol. He understands that this is any given Sunday. Oh, here he goes. Running through the back of the theater. He just ran out of a door. He ran all the way out of the exit door. Oh my God, he's coming through the other exit door.
House lights.
Here he comes. Up the stairs. Hold on, he's out of breath. He falls down. We've seen this before. He still has the dildo. He just let it. Oh, he's taking off the singlet. What's happening here? We've never seen this one before. This is very interesting. I don't know exactly what's happening. This is the part where we get kicked off at YouTube. And, wow. Okay. Wow. I forgot how weird his ass was. Coming back. He's out of breath.
He's out of breath. It's been a couple months.
This is easy. Whoa, wait a second. What is this? What is this? Oh, a backflip. Wait, he's going. Wait a second.
This
wait,
show is wait, over.
Wait, he's not done. Hold on. What he is won. He doing? What is
he's
doing?
He's got a bottle.
Wait a second. He's going back to the drums. Holy shit. Without a doubt, the greatest Mexican drum off of all time. Brought to you by Whistle Pig, this drum off. Whistle Pig whiskey, the only, one of the only 100% rye whiskeys. I love this stuff. I drink it all the time.
I just tried to talk into my Whistle Pig.
I mean, my goodness, I think we all won this competition, but just for the sake.
And that's his real dick, by the way, guys.
Yeah, by the way, yeah, there's no stuffing. That thing needs its own sombrero.
That's where Joe.
Michael Gonzalez putting the sombrero. Michael, stand next to Joel for a second, though. Just for the sake of historical statistics, we have to ask, how many of you have Michael Gonzalez winning that Mexican drama? That's good. That's good.
How, Woo!
How many of you have Joel Jimenez winning that?
I voted for everybody.
You know what that means. That means...
It almost wasn't fair.
Well, it's
he kind of should have went first.
Wait, but you know what that
Rating
means?
Rating defending, Joe. You know all about that.
I do. I appreciate what you did.
He still has glass on his head.
Oh, he's going to do it again. Woo! Oh, there it is. Wow. One of the greatest drummers in the game. One of the weirdest asses I've ever seen in my life. It's unbelievable.
There was so much else going on. That's the problem. One guy drummed. The other guy did a lot more.
Absolute chaos.
It's not fair.
Joel has
It's
a...
like, what are the parameters of what we're doing here? You're right, dude. But I'm
Joel has
up
a
for
huge
you.
Piece of glass still on his head.
Yeah.
There's a piece of glass sticking out of his skull currently. He said that hurt more than I thought it would. Wow, what a way to end this show. Thank you, Joelberg. Thank you, Michael Gonzalez. Thank you, Whistlepig, for sponsoring the drum off. Thank you, Fix Vodka, for sponsoring the band. Guys, how about a big hand for the band, everybody? Jetski Johnson, also brought to you by Ridge Wallet, as well as that incredible giveaway.
Wait.
We have the coolest sponsors in the world that really stepped up for this one and hit some fucking real fucking home runs with us. Jetski, this is your first time on the show in months. We're so happy to have you. Anything you want to say?
It feels so... I said before, it feels like my parents got divorced. Now I'm visiting Dad with his new family. And I love it. I love being here. This is great. And I
Guys, make some noise for Jetski Johnson, huh?
I do want to say real quick, the rest of the band really wanted to be here, but they all died. No, they really wanted to be here. They love you guys. We love you guys. And the second thing is we have merch.
if
you want some cool shit.
You'll be out front. You'll be out front in the sidewalk,
yeah,
right?
In the sidewalk area. There's going to be some merch. Ryan J. Belt slinging Kill Tony 500 posters. Ryan, what'd you draw back there for us tonight? Let's check it out. While everybody was goofing around having fun, this guy was at serious work. It's small. It's small but fucking mighty. My God, you did all that during this? The details are absolutely incredible. It's every single person that was on the show. That is incredible. And
let's check on Chris Rogers' art. He's
also
been drawing.
Local Austin artist Chris Rogers drew something as well.
Whoa!
Oh, shit!
Me. I love it. That's me.
Dude,
all right.
That's amazing.
I'll take that. That's going to be on my wall.
Dude.
That's awesome.
That should be in your bedroom.
500 in homage of the movie 300. There's Chris Rogers' art. RyanJEbelt.com for everything Kill Tony, the official artist of Kill Tony. All the tour posters, the new Kill Tony, the coloring book, RyanJEbelt.com. Support great artists.
Chris Rogers' art.
Guys, here to say something, and also, wow, what a performance. How about one more time for Joel Jimenez, huh?
Tony, I just want to say, it's so great to be here in Austin. Thank you guys for coming out. A lot of work and shit you guys don't see goes into getting to a podcast to 500 episodes like this. It's a big team. And we all try to pull our weight to make a good show for you guys. That being said, can we get a big hand for Jeremiah, for Chroma Chris, for Pat Reagan, everyone that's been a part of the band in the past of this show, Ryan J, everybody. Thank you guys so much. Have a great night.
Yeah, absolutely. I agree. The great Ali Makovsky, Malcolm Hatchett, Sarah Weinshank, Kim Congdon. These people all born and bred through the fucking tough work of writing a new minute every week in front of the public. An incredible, crazy system. And guys, how about a hand? What cooler guest to have in Austin, Texas than Joe Rogan, everybody? Come on.
All bullshit aside, this is a wild show. This is one of my favorite shows that I've ever done, ever, in any format, in any medium. This tonight was one of my favorite shows ever. And one of the reasons why... because I tricked Tony Hinchcliffe into moving into Austin, Texas.
You did.
And I tricked Red Band.
He tricked us. He said, move here. Get away from all the homeless people in traffic.
But it's going to work out. We got a plan. And one of the reasons why we even wanted to do it here is because this place has a very unique and awesome energy. It really is. It's amazing.
The key is we just gotta not fuck it up while it expands. Yep. And I think we can do that.
Yep. Thank you to the Paramount Theater for having us. This is chaos. I'm sure they're used to incredible symphonies and musical acts that don't come in with dildos and broken bottles and lap dances.
Thanks to all the comics that waited that didn't get up.
Yep. Absolutely. And how about one more hand for the band, everybody? Michael Gonzalez, D Madness, John Dees, Matt Muehling. Absolutely incredible. Thanks one more time to our amazing sponsors of this show, Ridge Wallet, Fix Vodka, and Whistle Pig.
Yellow and the red rose.
Yes,
don't forget
the yellow
about
and red rose. Rock solid. All of those sponsors are local Austin companies that are already having fun playing with us, goofing around, taking a chance, and we're all growing together.
Till the next 500, guys.
Thank you,
Thank
Austin,
you so
Texas.
Much. Good night, everybody. Thank you.
We are all in this together. We love you guys.
Yeah. Nah, niggas tell me how.
The trick if you could pay that. A small village, you could say that. But you'd rather take your brain, roll to Rodeo, let her raid that. No telling, hell no. Middle finger, the COINTELPRO. Stick it to the real like it's Velcro. What other country can you sell blow? And for less than a kilogram, you get an elbow. Getting high, never come down. Round up your guy, let me run it down. Soon as it dries, I'ma run the town. I fantasize shooting Trump down. A shot for every black man who got gunned down. By the police with no conviction, still they run round. When we protest, they tell us pipe down. For Trayvon and Mike Brown. CNN wanna make it black-white. Cause we hit the action with a black light. Make no sucker act right.